Texas battered voter syndrome.
I fell for the same old lies. They were just playing with my emotions, telling me what I wanted to hear. That's not right.
Stop the insanity of voting for the same old abusers. Declare your independence from the two-party system and join the New Hampshire Liberty Party today at nhliberty.info.
Lock it here for more live content. Free Talk Live is next on the Liberty Radio Network. You're listening to the Liberty Radio Network at lrn.fm.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 12, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,158, up $3. Silver opened at $15.58, up 8 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $292.45. Today's precious metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. In the news, two police officers were shot and seriously wounded early this morning outside the police department in Ferguson, Missouri. Fox News reports that St. Louis County Police Chief John Belmar held an early morning news conference and stated that a 41-year-old officer from St. Louis County was shot in the shoulder, while a 32-year-old officer from suburban Webster Groves was shot in the face. Both officers were taken to a local hospital with their conditions described as very serious. The shooting came amidst protests that followed the resignation of the town's police chief. Chief Thomas Jackson announced he would resign following a report from the U.S. Department of Justice that condemned the practices of the Ferguson Police Department. Jackson is only the latest in a line of recent departures after the Justice Department's investigation concluded. The report found that the Ferguson PD was guilty of unlawful and unconstitutional practices. The Justice Department also found widespread racism in the police department and municipal court. Despite calls to shut down the police department, Ferguson Mayor James Knowles said the city is committed to keeping the police department open. On Wednesday afternoon, protesters gathered in Decatur, Georgia, to protest the shooting death of a military veteran at the hands of a police officer. Anthony Hill was a 27-year-old military veteran suffering from bipolar disorder when he was shot by Officer Robert Olson. The officer reportedly found Hill running around naked in a suburban apartment complex. The officer said Hill came towards him and would not listen to warnings. Olson reportedly appeared shocked after the shooting and was seen sitting down on the street with his head in his hands. The Georgia Bureau of Investigation will now handle the official investigation. Protesters rallied outside of a county courthouse and marched through the streets, shutting down busy intersections. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to save big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 12, 2015. Make sure you check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On Wednesday, the Associated Press announced they were suing the State Department to force the release of emails and government documents from Hillary Clinton's time as Secretary of State. The AP filed suit after repeated Freedom of Information Act requests went unfulfilled. The requests are seeking materials related to Clinton's public and private calendars, correspondence between her and aides involved in her expected presidential campaign, and Clinton-related emails on the Osama bin Laden raid and NSA practices. Two Texas state senators have introduced a new bill that would require warrants for the use of Stingray cell phone surveillance. Senators Craig Estes and Rodney Ellis introduced Senate Bill 942, which would require warrants for GPS tracking devices, international mobile subscriber identity locators, including Stingray cell phone surveillance devices, also known as cell site simulators. On March 9th, the bill was referred to the State Affairs Committee. Stay tuned to Liberty Beat for more on this bill. The United States is sending $75 million worth of military equipment to Ukraine. The U.S. military is sending armored Humvees, drones, and counter-mortar radars, but none of the requested lethal aid. Military officials said the new assistance is part of ongoing efforts to help Ukraine defend against aggression. The equipment includes a small Raven drone system, which can be launched by hand, as well as 30 heavily armored Humvees and 200 other regular Humvees. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Shrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich. March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use coupon code LibertyBeat for $25 off your ticket. That's coupon code LibertyBeat. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 12th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Following earlier reports of 27-year-old Mark Felder's profound and startling level of pride in his alma mater, the University of Miami alumnus spoke to Onion reporters about his strong affection for the academic institution that left him totally unprepared for the job market and floundering in $50,000 of debt.
I would not trade my time at the University of Miami for anything. Miami has the best college experience in the country, hands down. I had an awesome time there, and it's an amazing place. We've got awesome bars, awesome sports, an awesome campus, and we're pretty much right next to the beach. I mean, what more could you want? You'd have to be crazy not to go there.
Felder, who paid over $140,000 in tuition, told reporters he takes an annual trip to see a Hurricanes football game and visit the university that failed to teach him any marketable job skills whatsoever, leaving him so financially helpless he was forced to move back in with his parents after graduating.
AMI, fight. Yeah, it's all about the U, baby. All about the U. That's what I'm talking about. Go Canes, baby.
For more on this story, check this week's Onion Review.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. This live edition of Free Talk Live, it's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
That's right. Ian, our normal first chair host, is off, well, it, really any evening between Tuesday and Thursday that he wants to take off, so that's generally when he's gone. So anyway, give us a call, 855-450-FREE. The Skype username is lrn.fm. All you have to do is send us a contact request there. We'll get it sometime probably within the first 10 minutes or so that you send it, and then you can call in and usually sound a bit better on Skype. So it's 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733 or lrn.fm on Skype. Johnson, I had something all ready to go with in the first slot, but I really like this article that you brought in, so we're going with it.
It's not even really an article. Well, I guess it's kind of an article. It's a Gallup.com poll. Okay. Well, it's actually just a Gallup poll. So apparently for the past 4 months, according to Gallup, which, you know, you got to take Gallup with a grain of salt sometimes, but, you know, they're normally, they kind of have a little bit, of a sort of a more pro-government, sort of liberal kind of bent to them in general. But in this particular instance, the Gallup has now has stated that government is now listed as the top problem for the United States. And it has been listed as the top problem by most Americans for the past 4 months. The economy is still among the top problems, and then another sort of a satisfaction with the direction of the way the United States is going is also another problem, along with unemployment.
You know, it's I saw some poll online where, you know, the popularity of Congress was at like 5%,
right?
And you know, it's been recently vacillating somewhere between 5% and 10%, you know, just above cockroaches, in some cases below cockroaches, as a matter of fact, and Nickelback, apparently. I guess there's a thing about disliking Nickelback. I don't have that thing.
Right.
I don't really know. I mean, I'm sure I've heard a couple of songs by Nickelback, but, like, I'm just not married to that. John Cougar Mellencamp, on the other hand, like, I could have, you know, something to say about that. Little Ditty by Jack and Diane. Man, terrible songs, in my opinion. Anyway, so, yeah, I mean,
that song's, you know, super catchy. What are you talking about?
it sold some albums. There's no doubt about it. Little pink houses. The fact is that, you know,
he's like an upbeat Bob Dylan.
I had a contract at one point, an actual employment contract that stipulated, among other things, that they could not play Dylan in the office.
Wow.
Yeah, like, totally not into Dylan. Like, it was the only guy on the contract,
wow,
too, right? Like, the only name on the contract besides mine, Bob Dylan. So people perceive the legislators in this country to be a bunch of liars and thieves and crooks. But somehow or another, they feel like we've got to have them. You know, like this is the only system we could possibly live by. I say if an organization's that far gone, get rid of it.
Right.
Maybe there needs to be something else in its place. I couldn't tell you. For one, I don't understand why the Senate exists at all. The Senate was intended to be an organization that it represented the states, right?
Right.
But now it's essentially a representative body just like the representatives.
Sure.
So what's the point in running, having two representative bodies?
Right.
So why not get rid of the Senate and add more seats to the House, or, you know, just get rid of the Senate? I mean, none of this makes any sense. Rent it out for mini storage or something like that. I have no idea what they do with the Capitol building, that wing of the Capitol building. But
I kind of wonder, though, like, wouldn't the founding fathers have really kind of written that in or thought of that in some way? I mean, it seems like a lot of stuff was written, at least, I don't know, the Constitution seemed to be written with the future in mind to a certain extent.
Yeah, well, the Senate didn't get done away with as far as a state representing organization for, it was more than 100 years. So the founding fathers, you know, Thomas Jefferson felt like the tree of liberty needed to be watered periodically by the blood of tyrants and patriots. I mean, he basically didn't feel that you should be legislating what the next generation would do. And I tend to agree with him. I think all laws should essentially sunset after 10 years or something like that. And then if they're good, then Congress can re-up them.
Right.
That's what they should be doing.
Right.
Not keeping these things in place.
Right.
I mean, the rules change over time. Things change.
Yep. So, 10 years seems like probably too long. We should be more future forward thinking and make that every 4 years, let's say.
To really keep them busy. Yeah. I'm willing to be generous here and say 10. Just go ahead and give it a nice round number.
Yeah.
But nonetheless, I think that it's very interesting that Americans think so little of their leaders, as it were.
Right.
That, what was it? They believe it. They're the biggest problem in the country?
Sure. Let's go on. So Americans continue to name the government, 18%, as the most important U.S. problem, a distinction it has had for the past 4 months. Americans' mentions of the economy as the top problem, 11%, dropped this month, leaving it tied with jobs, 10%, for second place. Though issues such as terrorism, healthcare, race relations, and immigration have emerged among the top problems in recent polls, government, the economy, and unemployment have been the dominant problems listed by Americans for more than a year.
So supposedly the economy is getting better. Doesn't the government get credit for that? I mean, idea.
According to these polls, no. You can look at you can look at the graph and see that for a while, the economy, as the percentage of people listing it as a problem, was moving upwards. So it went from like 13% to 14% to 16%. And government as a problem on those same poll points went up from 15% to 70% and then stayed at 17% and now has risen to 18%. But while government being listed as a problem has risen to 18% in that same time frame, economy as a problem dropped from 16% to 11%. Hmm. So essentially,
now we know
people naming government as a problem went up 1%, while the people naming the economy as a problem went down 5%.
Now we know what the real unemployment rate is. Let's go to Todd calling in from Utah. Todd, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, first, I actually called for two things. First, you mentioned Bob Dylan, and is that a pro-Bob Dylan mark?
Oh, no, I am not a pro. Okay. Look, I think that he might get credit as, a great poet of the 20th century. I'm fine with that label. I just don't want to have to listen to his caterwauling.
I tend to, when I listen to the show, I get really angry at times at things that people say, but I tend to agree with things that you say more often, and now I'm getting to understand why I like Mark a little bit more. I have the same thing with the Bob Dylan, but the other thing is that everybody wants to be Bob Dylan, and I don't understand why they all want to be Bob Dylan. Yes, he writes some poetry, but he's not very talented.
Indeed.
Singing wise.
What's your other topic?
The real subject is, you know, you guys every day, I call in sometimes, I get cut off just on my own cell service, but every day it's harboring on police officers and everything, and I'm just tuning in for right now. I don't know if you guys have brought up the other side of it today where the two officers were shot in Ferguson.
No, haven't brought it up.
Which I think is out of the negativity of the anti-cops that's going around.
Yeah, I think that there's a lot of it. I think that police sort of have to address that problem is that, you know, there's this zeitgeist that cops are the enemy. And, you know, yeah, I mean, well, I think that probably, I would just guess this sniping has something to do with that.
Yeah, I was going to say, can I just say one more thing and I'll get off and listen to you?
But go right ahead.
It doesn't help, I don't think, when I can't remember who the guest was 2 days ago that talked about that FBI agents are just below cops at being the lowest rung of the human chain, food chain, and being scumbags. So those kind of comments don't really help the situation either.
Well, I'm not interested in helping.
Todd,
I'm not interested in helping the police. They have a lot of power, and they can help themselves. They can go about changes, work for changes inside the system. Since I have been working as an activist inside the system, I've noticed police get very involved in law passing. So I don't feel bad when they have ramifications for the laws that they apparently want in place. Do you want to hold on, Todd?
Yeah, hold on.
Okay, great. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Policies issued by American General Life Insurance Company, Houston, Texas. Not available in all states. For details, visit AIGdirect.com.
It takes a lot of courage to face your own death, but I'm glad I finally did. See, I was putting off getting life insurance to protect my family, even though I knew it was important. Then my neighbor's husband died. I watched her struggle emotionally and financially. It really made me face reality. If my husband died, how would I pay the mortgage, the car payments, or keep up the life the kids and I had? I realized I needed to get us life insurance right away. So I called AIG Direct. In less than 5 minutes, I had a quote. I was shocked at how affordable it is. Just $14 a month for $250,000 of term life coverage. I feel so much better knowing my family has protection.
Call AIG Direct right now for a free, no-obligation quote. The call takes less than 5 minutes, and you can save up to 70%. Call now, 1-800-463-9184. That's 1-800-463-9184. 1-800-463-9184.
Hi, this is Mark Edge, host of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the very economic engine that powers this country. With a printing press tethered to Washington politicians, bureaucrats, and central bankers, how can we put our trust in paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Come see gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold. With Washington, D.C. delivering more debt and printed promises, common sense tells us the future of the trend is obvious. Everyone listening should visit gold.freetalklive.com or call 877-357-9938. I trust Midas Resources for my gold, silver, platinum, and you can too. Again, I want you to have this book, and it's free. It's gold.freetalklive.com or 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more, all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
(855) 450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in. Talk about whatever's on your mind, as Todd has. We'll get him here in just 1 second. But I want to tell you about, well, Ian and I are jetting off to Austin, Texas. It's March the 28th and 29th. We'll be down there at the Moody Theater for the second annual Texas Bitcoin Conference. At this event, they will have, once again, the $1 Million Bitcoin 2.0 Hackathon. This is an event that I think is singular in the Bitcoin sphere, making the Texas Bitcoin Conference the most important conference in the Bitcoin sphere, is that they're giving away $1 million to really great ideas that are in the Bitcoin sphere. And I'm excited to see what comes out this year. Last year they had storage and you know, some other ideas that were just great. And I'd like to see what happened to those, what's going forward. I think this is going to be really exciting. There's going to be lots of great speakers there. Simbala Nair from IBM. She's the architect of their blockchain technology, Adept. George Gilder, this guy practically created Reaganomics. David Johnston, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Anthony DiOrio from Ethereum, Charlie Shrim, and lots of other speakers. Go to TexasBitcoinConference.com. Get your ticket. It's $125 if you use coupon code FTL. So normally it's $150. You save $25 by using FTL at TexasBitcoinConference.com. And $25 of that goes to Sean's Outpost to feed the hungry. So TexasBitcoinConference.com, coupon code FTL, and you can join us. We'd love to see you out there. It was a great event. Let's go back to Todd calling in from Utah. Todd, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Excellent. So just to recap in the last segment, you're concerned that the police officers who were shot yesterday in Ferguson, in part that this they might have been shot for sort of an anti-cop sentiment that's sweeping the nation, and that for instance, Free Talk Live might be involved in that in some way because, well, you know, we try to hold the enforcers of the law accountable on this program. Does that sound about right?
Oh, that's not exactly what I'm saying, okay. But yeah, you're pretty close.
Okay. So, yeah, I mean, and you know, my response to it is that it's hard for me to feel bad for people in power complaining about how they lack power. You know, I mean, police have the ability to change, to some extent, the systems in which they work. And if they don't, well, they always have the choice of not going to work the next day.
Well, you know, I worked as a correction officer. And
I worked with a lot of correction officers.
Yeah, I worked as a correction officer, and I worked in a minimum security prison, and I saw the power structure there, and and I didn't like the pay, and didn't like the some of the same things that Ian says all the time about, you know, I'm guarding people that bounced a check. In Kentucky, you know, you go to jail for bouncing a check. You do bounce. Go to jail for bouncing a check.
Pretty much anywhere in America, that's true. It's sort of an old law. You know, you can do anything you want with a credit card, but God, if you have a check, then you're going to go to jail.
Right. So, you know, I had my own discrepancies with it. And in our training, they said if an inmate ever tells you don't come to work the next day, it's a pretty good sign that you don't want to come to work the next day. But I live in a small town that has one of the highest police force per capita, at least in Utah, and they've done a really good job of community policing. I've called in before and talked about the ideas of community policing that were pretty big in the early 90s when I was in college, and then have kind of gone by the wayside.
Is this cops who aren't in cars? Is this basically cops not in cars? That kind of?
Yeah, well, on bikes. Yeah. And bikes and on, yeah. So my interactions, I've had some stupid interactions. I called in one time and talked about it too. But my interactions with these officers are that they tend to not want to poke and prod. They want to get to the situation. And I still think it's admirable that somebody will drive into a situation where somebody's actively shooting and take control of the situation. So that's my thing about police officers.
Oh, I think that absolutely.
The grip of power that happens as well.
Yeah, police officers tend to be the personality type. One of the personality types of police officers is the kind of person who will totally take a bullet for the citizenry. I absolutely think that's true. But there are other personality types that can be drawn to law enforcement, and those personality types not as great. And, people that want power, people that perhaps were pushed around, that kind of thing. And so
I think we've discovered that those personality types tend to be the ones that are rewarded in the police force and tend to be the creep, sort of like.
Well, I think there's different departments is what I think. I think some departments are much better than others. So if you had this, community policing force.
I think if you work in homicide, you're probably the only department that's probably the one that's makes sense.
Well, I want somebody to investigate murders in the world, but I also think that there are better police departments and worse police departments, and it has to do with leadership and incentives that are laid out. The problem is that there doesn't seem to be much policing of the. I mean, I've always said that I really believe that the problems come from the top down. These are hierarchical organizations. It would be difficult for the problems to come from the bottom up
right. In
policing organizations. So. You know, when we look at government organizations, generally what we see is incompetence tends to be rewarded. The economists have looked at this over and over again, and it's an unpleasant, I wouldn't call it a fact, but likelihood that incompetence can be rewarded in government organizations because people don't want competition in the higher spheres for the job. I mean, who do you want competing for your job? Some genius or some dum-dum? And so, that's kind of one of the reasons that these tend to be the case. Todd?
Well, I go one step further and say that in my experience and in places I've worked at, it's probably the reasons why I get to a point where I'm not progressing anymore is I won't do that cutthroat thing to rat my fellow employee out or to do something like that. To each their own, whatever. If it's something that's going to hurt somebody, of course I would say something, but I can see what you're talking about. I know officers in this town that have been that way that are no longer officers. So I know that the management in St. George and I don't have any relatives or anything in this town of officers, but I know that the managers in this town will take a call for a complaint against their officers, and they'll deal with it. And my complaint in St. George, Utah, is more the city fathers, not the police officers. It'd be more the city's regulations are pretty abstract and crazy.
I don't have any complaints about the cops in my town because there aren't any. Somehow or another, the town I live in manages to survive without a police force. There's the what we call the stateies, which are a state police force that'll come out if there's, some kind of murder or something like that to do whatever investigation. But, the average calls, basically speeding tickets and dog calls is what we call them when a dog's killed some chickens or something like that. Meh. That's all the cop would do, and people can handle it on their own. Todd, I really do appreciate the call. Thanks so much. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. I wouldn't claim for a second we don't need policing organizations, but I would claim that we would get a whole lot better service from law enforcement if we did away with the war on drugs. I think that that is the new Jim Crow, and that's the root of all of many of the problems in Ferguson. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Hey, it's Mark of Free Talk Live, and I want to tell you about a new way to be prepared for emergencies. Not just big emergencies, but little ones too. It's a source of backup power, so small that I can put it in my pocket or the glove box of my car, but it's so powerful that it can actually jumpstart a bus if I need it to. Sounds crazy, but it's not. I'm talking... Power Plus. If you get stranded in an airport, in your car, or you just want to go off the grid for a while... Plant. Run pretty much any kind of electronic device for hours, even days if you need to. The Pocket Power Plus can also deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power that can jumpstart almost any vehicle, even the coldest winter days. Comes with free jumper cables and an accessory pack. Best part, my listeners can now get Pocket Power Plus for half price by going to PocketPowerPlus9.com. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. Use coupon code FTL to save even more. Go to PocketPowerPlus9.com. PocketPowerPlus9.com, coupon code FTL.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, The Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. Hey! That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
Gabino lives in Palcapata, Peru. He buys old appliances like irons, radios, and TV sets, fixes them up, and resells them. He saw an opportunity to expand his business and needed a loan to buy more appliances. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan, and the expansion was a success. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel anytime. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what the readers of FreedomsPhoenix.com get every day. FreedomsPhoenix.com constantly providing the information, the real news about government policies, and the real relationship we all have with the coercive government. The real condition of the economy, innovations in technology, breakthroughs in energy, health, and computer science. Learn the truth well before it's admitted to in the lamestream media. The corporate media, nothing more than distributors of government propaganda. But now there's an alternative. FreedomsPhoenix.com. Constant news updates on the issues that affect your life in the most important ways. With liberty and property under constant attack, FreedomsPhoenix.com provides the understanding behind the propaganda, and it encourages the participation of its readers. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com. That's Freedoms with an S, Phoenix.com. FreedomsPhoenix.com. The revolution between the ears has already happened.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever is on your mind. This evening on Free Talk Live, it's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
855-450-FREE. ExpressCoin is the best choice for getting your cryptocurrencies. Whatever those cryptocurrencies might be, they have a bunch of them over there. Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin, just to name a few.
It's fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business over at ExpressCoin.com, so it doesn't matter whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. You can trust them. They'll do a great job. You can use a money order or a check to get your Bitcoins. You can even do it from your smartphone by downloading their app at ExpressCoin.com. Use coupon code FTL to get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency with no fee at all. So if you use coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com, you can get up to $40 worth of cryptocurrency at no fee. ExpressCoin.com, coupon code FTL. Let's go back to the phones. We have been all, just wall-to-wall calls this evening. Let's go to Arthur calling in from Colorado. Arthur, you're on Free Talk Live.
Howdy, how are you guys doing?
Doing all right.
What's on your mind?
All righty. So I was watching a couple of YouTube videos in the past couple of days, and I saw that the ATF just reversed their whole position on that supposed ban they were going to put in place on that SS-109-223 or 556.
You're going to have to tell us about it. I have no idea. It sounds like you're rattling off the digits of pi to me.
Actually, I heard about that as well.
You heard about it?
Yep.
You're familiar with that whole situation?
I am. Ridiculous. That ridiculous situation. Thank goodness they backed off of that, at least for now.
Yeah. They shelved it for now. They say they got to reassess their position on it.
So this is one of the most common forms of ammo in the United States. It's the
22 longs?
0.556, I believe, right?
5.56, yeah.
5.56, sorry.
What are those? Calibers? Millimeters? What the hell are those?
You probably know more about guns than I do.
Millimeter.
Okay.
I'm confused with all that.
What it is it's the ammunition that is for the AR-15.
Okay. So the ATF decided they didn't like a particular piece of ammunition.
Because it's associated with a particular gun. I mean, it's not limited to that gun. Yeah.
As if the AR-15 is... a more dangerous rifle than this is the AR-15 or the I thought the AR-15 was the 223 round. So you're talking about the AK-47?
I believe it's for the AR-15. I don't believe you're correct about the 223 round, but I also have zero confidence in I've got maybe 20% confidence in my knowledge in that area. I'm sure that some people right now, I bet the phones are going to light up with people going, "What?" How dare you get that ammo wrong?
It looks like the 5.56 might go in an AR-15, but I was
right then. Yeah, well, there you go.
Also, another name for it is .22.
All the facts I know about ammunition and guns I've learned from video games. Thank you.
So anyway, the ATF has backed off of their stance that they're going to outlaw the ammunition for the AR-15. Is that the idea?
Yes.
That's precisely what.
Why do you think that is?
Now, well, I don't know exactly. I can't speak for them.
Speculate. Wildly speculate. Yeah.
So from what I've heard on the internet, and I think it was like a tweet they put out or something, the response to their announcement was, "Oh, none of this makes any sense. What are you doing?" And it was like 30,000 letters or something they got. And that's supposedly what got them to back off.
Well, it does sound. I do believe that when there's a significantly large public outcry, that government agencies will back off.
Right.
Not every time. I like to use as a counterexample in this circumstance the. I think it was called the TARP. It was before the bailout. It was under Bush. And in this circumstance, they was like, "Oh, the economy looks bad. Let's give a bunch of money to a bunch of rich people." And that was the plan, essentially. And everybody responded, basically, "No, you don't." And one congressman described it as 50% of people said no, and 50% said hell no. And but they went ahead and did it anyway because it was for our own good. You know, it was for our own good, Arthur.
Yeah, of course.
And so anyway, they went ahead and did it anyway. But for instance, SOPA, I think, is a good example where the Congress decided the internet's just a little too free. Those people, they're doing dangerous things on the internet. So we're going to have to get in there and fix it. We'll take our group of liars and thieves and miscreants, and we'll go ahead and we'll police the internet. And the public said, "No, thank you. No, no, we're not going to do that. And they did back off a couple of times in that circumstance. So
one has to also dramatically question the wisdom of pissing off a large contingency of people who also happen to own assault rifles.
You think that scares the ATF?
That doesn't sound like a good idea.
I don't know if it scares the ATF, but I'm sure it would would scare any of the politicians who are associated with them.
I think this was a sort of internal rule. Many of these organizations basically have lawmaking ability because they make up their own rules.
Right.
So is this a rule as you understand it, Arthur?
Well, I believe the whole thing came about as, are you familiar with AR pistols?
AR pistols? No.
Yeah. It's basically... So the National Firearms Act outlaws any rifles with a barrel length of less than 16 inches. And so the shortcut around that is you don't put a stock on your AR-15 and you can have whatever barrel length you want.
Yeah, what in the world calls...
Doesn't the AR and AR-15, does that stand for assault rifle?
No, it's Armalite rifle.
Oh, okay.
What is a rifle with a barrel shorter than 16 inches? I mean, what, that doesn't even make any sense to me. I thought we were talking about shotguns here. I mean, a rifle with a with a barrel length shorter than 16 inches is a pistol, right? A pistol with a stock on it.
Well, if it had a stock on it, the ATF would classify it as a short-barreled rifle. But without a stock, they classify it as a pistol because you're not readily able to shoulder it.
What is the danger of a short-barreled rifle?
Well, they think, well, I mean, aside from the easily concealable and all that, there's really no, that's mainly what I'm going to get to.
That's crazy.
Okay, I can tell you what the danger of a short-barreled rifle is. This is simple physics on this one. Rifle, right? A rifle, the word rifle stands for the rifling in the barrel. So
there's
the
no
longer,
rifling in a pistol?
Well, there's rifling in a pistol, but there's much less rifling. The longer the barrel, the more rifling there is for the bullet to pass through, which causes the longer barreled weapons to be more accurate. So the shorter the barrel on the weapon, the less accuracy you're going to get in general.
What's
so
the difference
if a barrel gets short enough, especially if you're firing rifle rounds, I would assume that the accuracy would be dropped dramatically.
Like on a pistol?
Well, yeah.
I just don't see the difference between a short-barreled rifle
and
a pistol.
Also, but if it's a short-barreled rifle, you're firing, I believe, what would be a much larger round, so your chance of inaccuracy is probably a lot much greater. That's what I'm guessing, again, but that's what I would guess that the
problem is. There are bigger
is.
Rounds that go in rifles, but, I mean, I would assume that the rules on AR... I would assume that the rules on a short-barreled rifle would be the same. I guess it must have to do with the round size, because they're sort of pistol rounds and rifle rounds.
Right.
Arthur, thanks for the call. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE, if you can fix my gun ignorance.
Part of the reason why I was asking the question, and I do feel like kind of an ass for saying the thing about AR-15, does AR-15 stand for assault rifle? I should have known better than that. I should have known at least that much, that AR does not stand for assault rifle. But however...
Stands for Bushmaster.
No, it does stand for Armalite rifle, is what he said. But when you say AR pistol, that would be inaccurate, because Armalite, how can it be an Armalite rifle pistol? Because it's a rifle, not a pistol, right? I
guess people are just calling it what they want to call
it. There's so much complicated gun knowledge that I just don't know. And, you know, start including more of that in video games so I can learn it.
So the story you had brought in was basically a poll from Gallup where... What was the percentage? 5% of Americans? No, I'm sorry. The top reason that American, the top worst
18%
thing,
of Americans.
Yeah, 18% of Americans, the most Americans, agreed that the government was the top problem.
Facing the country right now. Yep.
So how can it face the country when the government really is the country?
Well,
I mean, what is...
That's debatable, but okay.
What is the United States if not an organization of liars
and
thieves
people.
In Washington, D.C.?
How dare you?
855-450-3733. Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges. This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
If the IRS has garnished your paycheck or seized money from your bank account, you need to get professional tax help now. Fast action is required to put a halt to these aggressive IRS collection tactics. You can count on the knowledgeable team of tax professionals at Wall & Associates. With over 30 years of experience, Wall & Associates has settled the tax problems of thousands of taxpayers for a small fraction of what they owed. For a free face-to-face consultation, call 1-800-425-4610 to put a wall between you and the IRS. 1-800-425-4610 or look for us on the web at wallandassociates.net. We solve tax problems. If you hire Wall & Associates today, you'll never have to talk to the IRS again. To stop the levies and seizures today, take action now. Call Wall & Associates at 1-800-425-4610. Wall & Associates, 1-800-425-4610. Based on actual cases, results may vary, not a solicitation for legal services.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about, well, all kinds of things we've been talking about this evening, from the people of the United States and a Gallup poll saying that the government is the worst problem in the United States to the cop shootings in Ferguson. You can give us a call at 855-450-FREE or anything else that's on your mind. Skype username is lrn.fm. It's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
855-450-3733. As if to put an exclamation point on the story where Americans find the government is the worst problem, a Texas representative proposes a bill to make the filming of police illegal for everybody but sort of the mainstream media.
Wow.
So, if you had to make a guess, Johnson, because I made a guess in my mind, what is the political party of the representative who wants to make
filming the police illegal for the average Joe?
Unfortunately, I'd guess Republican.
You would be right. Texas, on Tuesday, a bill was filed by Texas Representative Jason Villalba, from a Republican from Dallas, HB 2918, which would turn private citizens who film police into criminals. The bill attempts to usurp citizens of the ability to hold law enforcement accountable for their actions by negating people's ability to create an accurate and impartial record of police interactions. This is from the Free Thought Project, by the way. If passed, please, I can't imagine this thing's going to pass. This, all he's done is paint himself as, a target for people who believe in civil liberties.
Sure. Hopefully he's made himself unelectable.
Let's hope so. But he certainly, there's a lot of police agencies out there that certainly think that this is, police agencies and police organizations, that really think that this is great. I mean, I can't tell you how many police unions we've seen over the years that say filming the police is a bad idea. What? These police have privacy rights. And, you know, right now, the first time in human history when we sort of have the ability, we, the governed, have the ability to sort of police the governed, the watchers are actually getting watched for the first time in history, and generally they don't like it. They want to stop it.
Right.
Yeah. And mostly this is just not going to go anywhere. Police are going to get filmed doing their jobs because that's good for everybody from here on out. And most of us are getting filmed doing our jobs anyway. I mean, when you're a clerk at the convenience store, you're getting filmed the whole time.
Certainly be interesting to have a law like this go into effect where they have like a conflict between, like you say, no one can film the police except for media. And then have another law that comes into effect that says all police must wear body cameras. Oh, wait a minute. But they're not allowed to film the police either.
Well, they always have exceptions for themselves.
Well, yes, in practice, not always in legality.
Yeah, not always in legality, but
right.
who? No one has standing
right.
to bring a case at that case. Anyway. If passed, the bill would amend the current Interface with Public Duties statute to include language only allowing filming of the police within 25 feet by news media. Now, we've seen lots of stories where...
Oh, within 25 feet. So this sounds like not a law to ban filming of police, but to create a circle of protection around the police, that someone must be beyond 25 feet from a police officer if they're filming them.
What if you are having an interaction with the police officer?
And you have to tell the, you have to back 25 feet away from the police officer and say, I'll interact with you from here.
Well, as far as I'm concerned.
Because I'm not going to stop filming.
He can interact with me through my attorney
right.
from his station.
Right.
I don't have any reason to be interacting with him. But, this is obvious. This is basically a restraining order put on every American.
Right.
And it's ridiculous. But anyway. News media is defined.
I would like to see this law. I would actually like to see someone attack this law and just slightly rewrite it so that it says that if the citizen is holding a camera, the officer has to back 25 feet away. No matter what. Like they pull you over, you pull out a camera, they got to back 25 feet up. Go across the road if that's what has to happen. You can shout at me from over there. Sorry, officer.
I can't hear you. I can't hear you.
Like either that or you can waive your right to not be filmed. You know?
The likelihood of the law you're hoping for seems really, really remote.
It's just as dumb as this one.
Oh, yeah. This is a. I sincerely hope that this Jason Villalba has made himself completely unelectable. But who knows? The fact is that these Americans might consider Congress to be the government to be the biggest problem in the nation. They will reelect more than 90% of them come the next time around. So I don't expect that Jason...
Garbage sure is a big problem. Who's running for office? Well, I like that guy. His name is good, and he looks like... His hair sure is pretty.
Yeah, I was participating in the town election yesterday, the day before yesterday, and then the town meeting was going on, and I thought it was more of a study in human interaction than anything. The human, sort of their behavior in groups. Right. What's the name of the study where the...
I don't know. The only thing about Gallup, though, there is a skew there, right? Because they only, you know, polled like 1,000 people.
Yeah.
You know, to get those results. And then here's the other problem. All those people own phones.
Telephones?
Yeah.
Well, if
that's a pretty huge skew right there.
If
I mean,
old people consider the government to be the biggest problem in the United States, then I don't imagine young people are any less on board with
but
that.
But I don't know that it's not, you know, necessarily that. It could be cell phones. It could be. It's also the type of people that take polls. You know, there's some skewing there that goes on that I think is probably fairly large. And the other thing that you have to take into consideration is, you know, like the sheer stupidity of the bottom level voter. You know, when you say 90% of these people are going to get reelected, it's like, well, yeah, but also probably 90% of voters don't know anything beyond these, you know, people's names, because so many voters are just so incredibly dumb.
Well, yeah, they're ignorant, that's for sure. Yeah. I like to use the term dumb because
ignorant,
I think it applies.
Sure,
but you remember the Ash study? We had talked about this on the air in the past. This is a study where you have basically one person and five Confederates who are sitting at a table. They're shown some lines mm-hmm. and said to compare it, you know, a set of three lines, compare it to one line.
Right.
And say, which one is the same length? Right?
Right.
So the first three or so, they guess the right one. Everybody goes down the line right there in front. So A, 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 A. And then the real person gets it and they say A. And then this happens over yeah. and over for three times. And then on the fourth one, they pick an obviously wrong
right,
line.
Right.
And they all agree that it's the wrong line.
Yeah, you know, most of them are actors.
And this person, yeah, well, they are actors. And
right.
then the last person is like, and he agrees with them. And in many cases, like 2/3 of the time, they just go ahead and agree. And what that says to me is that there's basically 2/3 of the people who are unqualified to give their opinion
right.
when it comes to a vote.
Right.
I went to town meeting, and it was amazing to me how many things passed. These people passed $1 million budget on a voice vote.
So sometimes I feel like I've
come up with nobody dissenting.
Sometimes I feel like I've come up with some good ideas on Free Talk Live, and I've floated them out of the ether, and they've come back, like, you know, sometimes months later, sometimes years later in an interesting way. And I'm going to float one of those ideas now. I would like to see somebody form or use one of these do exit polling, right? Like one of these exit polling companies. I would like to see some publications, some media publications about like doing exit polling at elections, and have media publications about what the results would have been if the only people voting in that election were property owners. How would it have affected the election results if we were in the times where only property owners could vote?
You think this
And I'm saying this, by the way, as somebody who does not own property. I'm not a property owner. So I would if the right of property, if the rights to vote were taken away from everyone who does not own property, I would lose my right to vote, which would suck. But I do feel like property owners are the only ones with skin in the game.
I don't.
I feel like, yes, okay, some people have some skin in the game to a certain extent, but for the most part, the people who are most affected, and I feel like should be, in some ways, the only ones making the decisions, because they're the only ones who are going to be, for the most part, educated. You can depend that
no.
a property owner is going to be more educated than...
I think more educated. I suppose you could say they're more educated.
Involved.
But why not just give a test to see whether people are qualified? I mean, there's a...
Well, sure, that would be nice too, but then you get into all sorts of weird, you know, like you could get into all sorts of weird racial issues and
you could.
Bigotry and all sorts of weird stuff.
That's certainly... There's a history of that, but yeah. why not give the same test that they give to people to become a U.S. citizen to see whether or not you're qualified to vote? You have to get a test to drive. I mean, if you're going to make a qualification for voting, it seems like as good as any. As far as
sure.
I'm concerned, legislators should have to agree 100% on laws, and that would solve most of our problems. 855.
We people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
It's a terrifying thought. You're trapped somewhere without a radio and no access to GCN shows, a doctor's office, the DMV, your mother-in-law's.
Come on, stay for dinner.
That's what makes the newly redesigned GCN Live app a true lifesaver. Listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programming on your smartphone, wherever you are. Download yours free on iTunes or Google Play. The new GCN Live app. Don't leave home without it.
Are you tired of your taxes funding endless occupations around the world? Antiwar.com is run by people who understand that wars abroad become wars at home, wars on our freedoms. Antiwar.com is dedicated to bringing you the latest in news, views, interviews, and reviews from the top movers and shakers in the anti-occupation movement. Antiwar.com has it all, from thorough foreign policy analysis to interviews with whistleblowers who used to run the military-industrial complex. Anti-war, pro-free market. That's Antiwar.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Thursday, March 12th, 2015. Silver is trading at $15.57 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,157 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $294. Antiwar.com reports the unprecedented effort by Senate Republicans to sabotage ongoing U.S.-Iran relations with a letter earlier this week in which they openly warned Iran of their intentions to dishonor any agreements President Obama made was a lighthearted jest, according to Republican aides. One aide complained after reports that the letter was likely a felony offense and could amount to treason, quote, "the administration has no sense of humor," end quote. Republican non-signatories to the letter are now saying it was a bad idea, while the signatories are trying to reframe it as a goof, apparently done as some sort of weird form of performance art. Secretary of State John Kerry yesterday reiterated that despite the letter, Congress does not have a constitutional right to change diplomatic agreements that have already been signed. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu seemed to be trying to claim credit for the letter by contrast, suggesting his recent congressional speech fueled the letter in defiance of diplomacy he opposes. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co. UPI reports Ferguson, Missouri Police Chief Thomas Jackson turned in his resignation Wednesday, just days after a scathing Justice Department report criticized the department for racial discrimination. Jackson is the third top official in the city to resign since the DOJ report. Lieutenant Colonel Al Eckhoff will become acting chief of the police department while the city launches a nationwide search for a new chief. Ferguson Mayor James Knowles told reporters Jackson resigned because he is an honorable man. City Manager John Shaw, the city's most powerful official, quit his post late Tuesday. The DOJ report blamed him for overseeing the city's financially driven policies, which led to widespread corruption. In a page-long resignation letter, which the city called a mutual separation agreement, he offered a staunch defense to the DOJ findings, writing, "While I certainly respect the work that the DOJ recently performed in their investigation and the report on the city of Ferguson, I must state clearly that my office has never instructed the the police department to target African Americans, nor falsify charges to administer fines, nor heap abuses on the backs of the poor. Any inferences of that kind from the report are simply false. The report said Shaw played a major role in the financially driven police and court system that was used to bolster the city's coffers. One email shows Shaw congratulating the police and courts for great work, as he was told there was a long line of people waiting to pay fines.
You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for precious metals or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio.
Reuters reports a Johnson & Johnson subsidiary pled guilty on Tuesday to selling liquid medication contaminated with metal and agreed to pay $25 million to resolve the case. The subsidiary, McNeil Consumer Healthcare, pled guilty to one federal criminal charge in the case. In 2010, the company launched mass recalls of certain children's over-the-counter medicines, including infants Tylenol and children's Motrin, made from its Fort Washington, Pennsylvania plant. It was the latest in a series of recalls at the time. There were far-reaching multiple recalls from 2008 to 2010 involving hundreds of millions of bottles and packages of consumer brands such as Tylenol, Motrin, Rolaids, Benadryl, and other products due to faulty manufacturing. The recalls kept widely used products such as children's Tylenol off pharmacy shelves and seriously tarnished Johnson & Johnson's once sterling reputation. In the case involving metal particles, the troubles began in May 2009 when a consumer complained after noticing black specks in the bottom of a bottle of infant's Tylenol. The specks were found to be nickel and chromium particles. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In a move that puzzled patrons of the global fast food chain, McDonald's launched an extensive ad campaign this week entitled, "And Yet Is Not Beef Itself an Expression of Wanton Lust?" to air at prime time on several networks. The lengthy advertisement, which makes scant reference to any products or promotions, posits to viewers that perhaps beef is merely a symbolic expression of lust in its most wanton and depraved form.
When we call for beef, what are we really asking for? Is it the caress of a gentle lover? Or the blade of an executioner? The rage of steel on bone? Would you yourself deny beef? Would beef deny itself of you?
In other news, a spaced-out flower child is grooving on a doobie wave. A new study reveals nothing Pfizer's lawyers can't take care of, and the parents of an adorable child on a TV show are most likely insane. Thus ends nature's majestic cycle of weekly news reviews, only to gracefully begin itself anew in exactly 1 week's time.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind on Free Talk Live this evening. It's Mark.
And Johnson.
Ian, our main host, is, well, it's his night off, so there you go. You can give us a call, talk about anything you want here on Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. We were discussing an article from the Free Thought Project where apparently a Texas representative, Jason Villalba from Texas, has recommended, has put in a law that would apparently make it illegal for your average citizen, not good old mainstream media folks, but your average citizen to film the police within 25 feet. So that means if you are in an encounter with a police officer, you cannot film that encounter. Now, I mean, I can see why you wouldn't want, why police wouldn't want you within a certain distance of, you know, them while they're doing their job.
Sure.
Getting involved and, you know, that sort of thing. Some cases,
I don't think that they should necessarily have that, right? I mean, I guess maybe beyond, like, you know, 1 foot.
Yeah, I think that there's probably probably some rule already about interfering with a law enforcement officer in the course of his duties. The thing is you'd have to prove that, as opposed to giving just this sort of, you know, prescription of how far one has to be.
Right.
Now, this Jason Villalba here, he says that news media, he defines them as a radio or television station that holds a license issued by the Federal Communications Commission, not Free Talk Live. So Free Talk Live is a nationally syndicated radio program on more than 150 stations across the country, but we do not have a license that's issued by the Federal Communications Commission.
You don't count.
B, a newspaper that is qualified under Section 2051.044. I know people read that all the time. One of my favorites. Got it right in the bathroom. Government code to publish legal notices, or is a free newspaper of general circulation that is published at least once a week.
FPP.cc.
And available, and I think FPP.cc is monthly, isn't it?
Oh, is that? I don't know.
It's
monthly.
Newspaper they produce over there at FPP.cc. At least once a week, or available and of interest to the general public in connection with the dissemination of news or public affairs. I don't see why... And available and of interest. Or a magazine that appears on a regular interval that contains stories, articles, essays, or by various writers that is available and of interest to the general public in connection with the dissemination of news or public affairs. Now consider for a second that there are laws, rulings throughout, not laws, but rulings from courts throughout the country that basically say anybody who has a blog is the news media. And I think this is fair. As a matter of fact, I think anybody who thinks they're going to start a blog tomorrow is the news media. I mean, if you see a story that goes down and you want to make a news career out of it by breaking that story on the internet, well, by God, you should be able to do that. That's your right as an American citizen. Under the rules here that Jason Vallalba suggests is that you can't start a new magazine or a new newspaper. If you want to film police. So you can only film police if you have an established magazine or newspaper that has come out on a regular basis. But you can't start a new one next week and break some story about police abuse or something like that. You can't do that. And by the way, what good is it of your newspaper or magazine to audio and video record an interaction, right? Like, these are pretty old technologies where you're using a pretty new one. So, yeah, I mean, I think that they also, it cuts out Rush Limbaugh, Free Talk Live, Sean Hannity, Michael Savage, every one of the nationally syndicated hosts, unless I suppose many of them do work for a radio or television. They probably work for radio stations Rush has his out of his home. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, some of these shows have flagship stations. Free Talk Live doesn't. We're one of the new breed where you don't need a flagship station. So I guess I want to know. I mean, what do you people think about this? When your representative decides that it's appropriate, somebody who is elected to and swore an oath to the Constitution, that includes the First Amendment, the right to the freedom of the press, suggests that the people can't go and film the police. Do we need a stipulation in the First Amendment that says, oh, yeah, except for government agents in the course of their duties, that all these decisions coming down from the circuit courts that say that filming the police, you know, public officials on public property while they're working for public money on public time, that's okay, that somehow those judges are all mistaken. This is what I want to know. Now, we had a caller earlier who suggested that the shooting in Ferguson, Missouri, yesterday might be a result of an anti-cop sentiment that is sort of percolating. And I would tend to think that that's probably true. I don't disagree with that statement. What do you do? How do you watch the watchers when the watchers clearly, when we can see the videotape, when you can see police officers kicking the crap out of people in real time through Bamboozer and these sorts of apps, how do you stop that? How do you control that? The only thing you can do is videotape. The only thing you can do is speak out.
Yep, and that's true, and they don't want people to do that. You know, they don't want people to have any of that power. I mean, because that's what it is. It's just like, well, how can we take away any power that people have at all?
That's exactly what it is.
You know?
Government is, by its nature, a conservative organization. It is intended to conserve the state, right? To conserve the status quo, to, you know, hold things the way they are. And they don't like change. They shouldn't like change. They're the ones with power. Who wants to change away from a system where they have power? Well, not a government agent, generally, because they're attracted to power, generally. There certainly are some, I'm sure, that aren't. But, I mean, you know, the very idea that these people are going to police themselves is patently ludicrous. And there's thousands of years of history that we can look at to see that states are terrible at controlling themselves. Even if you look at democracies. I mean, George Orwell didn't write 1984 about a totalitarian regime. The, you know, it was to show what happens to democracies. Aldous Huxley, however you pronounce that, I'm not exactly sure.
That sounds about right, I think.
He wrote his Brave New World as a warning to people about what the world is going to be like. That it is quite possible that there'll be a contingent in society that enjoys their chains, argues for their chains, demands that other people enjoy the chains that they enjoy. And this is sort of the natural outcropping of a republic. We're told it's not a democracy. I think that this is really just prattling nonsense. The difference between a democracy and a republic? Come on. Was the Roman Republic an organization that respected rights? Because that's what people, I'm a Republican, and that's what Republicans will generally say. We don't live in a democracy, we live in a republic. A republic is a...
Technically we live in a democratic republic, but anyway.
I think that that's probably the fairest thing to say is a democratic republic, but many people shorten it to democracy, and some people use the term republic, and I think that it's really just PR where Republicans don't like the idea that the word that's usually used to describe democratic republics as a democracy. So they want to reclaim the term republic so that Republicans look like they have more social currency, as it were. But, you know, I mean, if the United States is an organization where we elect representatives that has a constitution that respects rights, where was the Roman Republic's list of rights? I mean, certainly they had whatever those guys were that carried around those... things of twigs, I can't remember exactly, but they had the things on the back of dimes. There's these I can't remember what they're called, but you know, these bundle of twigs that they had that somehow, you know, gave them social notoriety or something. Anyway, I think that this is just an argument of semantics, frankly, and I don't think there's any point in it. There was at my town meeting, we had to vote on whether or not whether corporations were people. It was really hilarious that we put this non-binding vote to the people of Westmoreland. And it was close, mind you.
Wow. Yeah. It was close? Wow.
It was pretty close. Are corporations people? 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Policies issued by American General Life Insurance Company, Houston, Texas. Not available in all states. For details, visit AIGdirect.com.
It takes a lot of courage to face your own death, but I'm glad I finally did. See, I was putting off getting life insurance to protect my family, even though I knew it was important. Then my neighbor's husband died. I watched her struggle emotionally and financially. It really made me face reality. If my husband died, how would I pay the mortgage, the car payments, or keep up the life the kids and I had? I realized I needed to get us life insurance right away. So I called AIG Direct. In less than 5 minutes, I had a quote. I was shocked at how affordable it is. Just $14 a month for $250,000 of term life coverage. I feel so much better knowing my family has protection.
Call AIG Direct right now for a free, no-obligation quote. The call takes less than 5 minutes, and you can save up to 70%. Call now, 1-800-463-9184. That's 1-800-463-9184. 1-800-463-9184.
Gold isn't for you? Ted Anderson, president of Midas Resources, one of the world's premier gold and precious metal investing firms. I get it. You wouldn't buy gold if you believed that the government is doing a great job, that the Fed will stop handing out trillions of dollars like bailout candy, that Social Security would be there for you. That's not what's happening. You might even pass on gold if the stimulus package wouldn't fuel inflation, or that the dollar wouldn't lose value, or that your retirement would be secure. If all looks rosy to you, then now is not the time to buy gold. For the realists, there have never been more sobering reasons to diversify with gold. Since 2001, the U.S. dollar index has tanked 30% while gold has risen 300%. Right now, savvy investors are adding gold to their portfolios. You should too. Find out what they know. Call us and I'll send you 10 reasons why gold will do very well, free. 800-686-2237. 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. It's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
855-450-FREE. Or lrn.fm on Skype. You can get a free pound of coffee. All you have to do is go to coffee.freetalklive.com. There we have a subscription program that we've worked out with BuzzBox. And you sign up, you pay for the shipping, but it's a free pound of some of the best coffee you're ever going to taste. It's delicious, shade-grown, 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica beans. This is the best of the best coffee. There's, you know, none better. Now, you may have a preference of sort of the very best coffees, but they have so many varieties over there that you're going to find something that really works for you. It's better for you and better tasting. Coffee.freetalklive.com. And when you buy your coffee, continue to buy your coffee there, because the first one you get free, but it's a subscription program. You can cancel it anytime. But if you continue to get your coffee there, we'll be able to send money to people around the world through Kiva.org. It's a microloan program where we can loan to people around the world, helping them get the things that they really need in life, things that they've decided they need, a hand up rather than a handout. Because when they pay it back, and they do pay it back, we have, at this point, 100% payback, by the way. We're very lucky. We loaned it out to other people. It's coffee.freetalklive.com to help us with that. Coffee.freetalklive.com. Let's go to Mackenzie calling in from Utah. Mackenzie, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hi,
Hi, I just had a thought, and I'll be real quick, but someone had suggested we have two houses in Congress. We have a House of Representatives, we also have a Senate. However, the Senate does not represent the states anymore.
Yep.
You know, they have to be elected by popular vote, so what use are they? Why not get rid of them? My thought was, why not go back to their original use so that if they aren't representing the state and aren't accountable to the states, that the state legislature can recall them, just like before the whichever amendment which changed it to a popular vote.
It was 17th.
Let's have it. Was it the 17th?
I
think so, too. It's pretty close in there. Do you know the reason behind that amendment being passed?
I would assume it's just because people wanted more representation, but I could not say, no.
Actually, the history of that is because in Illinois, and it was during the time of Big Boss and incredible political corruptness around the turn of the century, in Illinois, the entire state legislature was bought off.
Mm.
And so they, you know, there was this outcry of, oh, we can't trust the state legislatures. They can be bought off. Therefore, all we can trust is the people. And, you know, democracies, pure democracies, always, you know, essentially implode at some point. Because
they result in socialism. I mean, basically, you know, it would be very difficult to say that you wouldn't be able to appeal to 51% of people by giving them free stuff.
Well, exactly, which is the problem. So let's just pass another amendment and make the Senate do what it's supposed to, because you're right. Essentially, the way it is, it's useless.
So what's it supposed to do? Represent the states?
It was supposed to represent state interest and be accountable to the state legislature so that, you know, if Virginia was getting out of control, it was a protection for the smaller states or the less populous states. If Virginia was getting out of control and Rhode Island didn't like it, then so the senators weren't doing what Rhode Island wanted. Instead, they were going along with Virginia. Then they could say, come back. You can't be our senators. We're going to have somebody else be our senators because we need to be represented against, you know, bigger groups or bigger interests. And so they are supposed to represent the interest of that state. And
I guess the difficulty would be here is that there was probably a great public outcry for what went on with the 17th Amendment, but there's no public outcry for this, right? Like, so the idea of getting an amendment through these days is really unlikely.
Right.
I think it was the Equal Rights Amendment was what they were trying to do when I was a kid, and nobody's even proposed one since then.
Well, right. And the reason there's not an outcry is nobody realizes that's what the original intent was. Instead, it's sort of like, well, we need to change governments. This government isn't working anymore. Well, what's happened is that the structure itself, the original structure, was good. But if the people that are there can no longer be trusted with the public trust, of course it's not working.
Well, I think that it's a pretty radical statement to say that the government was good prior to the 17th Amendment. I mean, we had all kinds of problems.
I don't mean that.
Okay.
I mean, the government structure itself, when the founders set it up, they looked at it. They had looked at every government that had ever existed in history, and they had said, okay, what happened with this one, and what were the problems with this one? And they came to amazing compromises and came up with a structure that they hoped could last, didn't have any idea, it was the American experiment, and hoped that statesmen would be statesmen instead of politicians. And certainly that's what we're having more and more, is politicians. It's all self-interest. That's why people don't trust them.
Well, I think when you look at the Alien and Sedition Act under Adams, this is one I like to trot out, and Thomas Jefferson, this bastion of freedom, he enforced it under his presidency too. These were obvious violations of the Bill of Rights. I mean, I
agree with you there.
Yeah, these went through that structure. So I don't know whether – I'm not prepared to say the United States is has the single best government on the planet. I don't know the answer to that. What I can see is that places like New Zealand and Canada have been rising on the economic freedom charts, that are out there, and the United States has been falling. So – maybe that's the result of a bad governmental structure? I don't know.
Okay. I think it's a result of corruption in our leaders.
Yeah, well, I agree with you. Why don't they have corruption in Canada?
Was, Well, I can't answer that. But my thought was, let's not just throw out the Senate. Let's try it again the way it was originally intended.
I have an addition. Mackenzie, I'll go with you. If we can agree that all the politicians have to agree 100% to pass a law.
No.
No?
No, well, you mean they have to agree with each other in order to pass a law? 100%?
Absolutely, 100%. Then you know that you get laws that 535 people have agreed upon. They'll be relatively powerless, and therefore the corruption will go away. Lobbyists trying to get 100% of politicians to agree on something are going to find that a Herculean task, and therefore most decisions will be left to the marketplace. They might have things like, it's wrong to kill people. It's wrong to set their houses on fire. It's wrong to rape people. They'll have laws like that because I think 100% of people can come to that conclusion. And by the way, I'm willing to step down to 85%.
Something like 2/3 or 3/4 makes more sense because under the Articles of Confederation, they couldn't even get 13 states to unanimously agree, which is why you had all the riots in between the ending of the Revolutionary War and before the Constitution was passed.
Well, that does sort of point out some of the difficulties. I mean, Rhode Island had to be threatened with a blockade in order to get the Constitution put through. So, you know, they didn't want it either. So the Constitution was kind of shoved down people's throats to some extent. Thank you for the call, Mackenzie. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. Free Talk Live. Hey, it's Mark of Free Talk Live, and I want to tell you about a new way to be prepared for emergencies. Not just big emergencies, but little ones too. It's a source of backup power, so small that I can put it in my pocket or the glove box of my car, but it's so powerful that it can actually jumpstart a bus if I need it to. Sounds crazy, but it's not. I'm talking about a breakthrough in portable power technology called the Pocket Power Plus. If you get stranded in an airport, in your car, or you just want to go off the grid for a while, the Pocket Power Plus becomes your own personal mini power plant. Run pretty much any kind of electronic device for hours, even days if you need to. The Pocket Power Plus can also deliver an enormous supply of on-demand power that can jumpstart almost any vehicle, even in the coldest winter days. Comes with free jumper cables and an accessory pack. Best part, my listeners can now get Pocket Power Plus for half price by going to PocketPowerPlus9.com. That's PocketPowerPlus9.com. Use coupon code FTL to save even more. Go to PocketPowerPlus9.com, PocketPowerPlus9.com, coupon code FTL.
Email is easy, instant, and free, and that can be real embarrassing. Email lacks the eye contact and body language you get in face-to-face conversation, or the tone of voice and other nuance you hear in a telephone conversation. Email is just words, often few words. We're all smothering in spam, so we often reply in terse fashion that's easy to misunderstand. And email doesn't cost you a postage stamp, and it lacks the deliberation time it'd take to walk to the snail mailbox, so it's easy to succumb to the stimulus response trap. When in doubt, don't snap back at snippy messages you get. You may have mistaken the sender's intent, and unless you're sending AOL to AOL, there's no unsend. For more tips on critical communication skills for the way things are now, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark, at freetalklive.com. The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
Sometimes you have to do things in emergencies that you don't do in normal times.
Like lock up Japanese Americans?
Look, you don't believe in the internment of the Japanese Americans?
The hell I don't. I don't believe in locking somebody up for not doing anything wrong.
Let me tell you something. There were Japanese Americans who assisted Japanese soldiers in the Hawaiian Islands at that time.
So grab all the families and throw them in a concentration camp. That's a great solution, Lou. That's something that should happen in the land of the free,
you
right?
See, I don't even like you using the term concentration camp.
That's what they were, Lou.
Because they were not death camps. They were.
It doesn't matter if there weren't gas chambers on the premises.
They were not death camps. You see, you're using euphemism.
I call them a concentration camp. You're concentrating people all in one location, Lou.
I don't, you know, you're giving it an implication that it does not have.
I think you should go to the Japanese Americans and ask them, Lou.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind, or you can use Skype. Our username is lrn.fm. Is all you have to do is send us a user request thing there, and we'll approve it probably within 10 minutes or so. And then you can call in and usually sound a bit better. Or you can use the old telephone lines, 855-450-3733. I wish that I didn't have to keep reading stories like this. But I feel like it's one of the things that Free Talk Live can change by bringing enough attention to it. Yes, it is extraordinarily difficult to change the political system, the atmosphere, government generally. But with enough pressure and enough sunlight on things, bureaucrats will change. And this is one of the ones that's sort of tenuous, because it's only relatively recently that our children, probably since Columbine, have been subject to this zero tolerance crap that goes on in schools. Now, it sounds great, zero tolerance for violence, but it results in things like this from KRDO in Colorado Springs, a Colorado Springs first grader. This is a child who is younger than my son, Jack. Was suspended from school after pointing his fingers at a classmate in the shape of a gun. 6-year-old Elijah goes to Stratton Meadows Elementary School. On Monday, he pointed at a classmate in the shape of a gun and said, "You're dead." According to his behavior report, an administrator spoke with him about being what being dead means and about not confusing make-believe or things in games with reality. And he received a one-day suspension for threats against peers.
You can't repeat your daddy like that.
What's that mean?
Well, why is this kid going around, if he doesn't know the meaning of this thing, why is he going around pointing his fingers at people going, "You're dead"? what's going on at home with this poor kid?
No, people, I mean, bang, bang, you're dead. I mean, this is as old as kids.
Yeah, I guess, maybe, but what, okay, I mean...
I think Jack talks about people being dead all the time. He was playing with some, he likes to play with my Risk game,
right.
And I think it's great because he learns the sort of the regions and that sort of thing in the process.
I don't know. There's a lot of possibilities for this thing. You know, like there could be this kid could be a bully, or it could be him repeating something and not really understanding the meaning of it.
Yeah, you know? I have to err on the side of believing that this is just rather normal. Too many times, there's too much of a pattern from the side of the school on schools on this, is that essentially there was a deaf kid named Hunter who the school wanted him to change his name. His name is Hunter, and right. the abbreviation for his name is sort of a wagging gun finger thing.
Right.
And they wanted him to change his name because he was making the gun finger.
Right.
The gun finger is verboten.
Right.
In school right now.
Right.
Now, I don't think that the kid was likely bullying another kid at this point. They were probably just doing make-believe.
I'd like to see kids like do the gun finger right all the time, like be doing the gun fingers and say, L.
Because it looks like L's?
Yeah.
If you
just
hold
to
them
mess
up,
with people.
If you
just
hold them up, you can tell you're right from your left that way. That's how
exactly.
I was taught. But, yeah, I mean, you know, does that mean you're shooting upward when you look at the
sure.
L? Yeah, maybe.
Celebrating a victory in some sports team.
The father goes on here. I know they have zero tolerance, but more of a maybe a no recess, his dad said. This is Austin Thurston. Going as far as a one-day suspension is a little extreme for a 6-year-old in first grade. a spokesperson for Harrison District School 2, which Stratton Meadows is part of, couldn't give us specifics about the case, but because it's part of the student's personal record. But she said school administrators feel that they issued the appropriate disciplinary action. She also said school staff speaks with students and parents before a suspension, and they consider current as well as previous behaviors. Elijah has been at the school since January. His dad said, well, he had minor behavioral incidences in previous school. This was the first time he got in trouble at Stratton Meadows. And I don't know how many kindergartners don't have minor behavioral issues. I mean, that's right. This is what school is, right? It's behavior modification indoctrination camp. I mean, that's essentially what it is. And that's what you have to do. I mean, you know, you're just talking about a primate here, and it has to be sort of taught, socialized into...
Yeah, just pump them full of Ritalin, and there won't be any problems.
Yeah. But I think that the problem with school is that it's designed to teach you how to sort of be a little factory worker, a little office drone. It's not really designed to make creative people. You know, the bell rings, you go do this thing. The bell rings, you go do that thing. No, you can't go potty now. You have to wait to go potty later. You know, all these things. This isn't conducive to making a creative being. Creativity is the most important thing in today's job market. Creativity is what's rewarded. People who are self-motivated. How can you be self-motivated when you're told what to do for 8 hours out of the day? I think that you can't make genius and you can't make creativity. You can't make inspiration, but you can kill all those things.
Yeah.
There's one thing common among kids who hate school. School. My son doesn't go to school. We have sent him to different classes and that sort of thing. And basically it's to be able to play with other kids. If he wants to do that, that's cool. But one thing I'm very, very clear on is I don't want somebody sort of indoctrinating my child, sort of holding him back.
Right.
He can already read at something like a third or fourth grade level. I don't want him reading with your kids because they can't read as well. I don't want him because if you have a group of 20 kids and you're trying to teach them to read, some are going to be below the mean and some are going to be above the mean.
Yep.
The result is the mean. And that means that the people above the mean are going to be pulled downward, and the people below the mean are going to they're going to attempt to pull it upward. What this results in is the mean isn't even at 50%. The mean moves to somewhere around 40%.
And
this
really
is what we call dumbing down.
Yeah, and here's the really unfortunate thing is that there are a lot of people out there, and I think this is particularly – well, I was going to say it was particularly true amongst liberals, but this is just me projecting. But essentially – I had a huge problem with school because I was definitely pulled down in school. I had, you know, I was tested, right? I'm in the, and this is multiple different tests, but to be in the 99th percentile for language. So in other words, my vocabulary, throughout my education, it means that if there are 100 people in a room, I'm basically speak.
Yeah. You know, it's fine.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. So, essentially, it came down in school. I was just, it was horrible, you
bored,
know?
Bored and frustrated?
Bored and frustrated constantly, but yet at the same time, not necessarily getting good grades because homework was just busy work nonsense. And
most
I hated being there. And you know, the teachers were saying, like, hey, this kid is gifted. You know, he could be in a gifted program. And, you know, and on one level, another level, he couldn't do the work.
By the time you get to the gifted program, they've sucked out whatever desire you have to do the work and to learn.
Not necessarily. It was just that I had a family that refused to not, you know, to put me in anything other than, oh, you need to go to government school and just go through the program.
I have read an article. I've read more than one article that it's anti-liberal to send your kid to a private school or to homeschool or to unschool to do these things. It's anti-liberal. Now, I'm not sure what they're defining liberal as.
I grew up in Connecticut, by the way, folks.
But the idea, basically what I've read in there is that your smart kid's going to be smart. It doesn't really matter. That if you take your smart kid out of the school, it drags down the mean and makes it worse for the other kids. So you have to sacrifice your smart kid's smartness to the altar of conformity.
Right.
It is amazing to read these articles written by these people, but they do it with a straight face. I remember this one lady talking about how she's judgmental. She says this, I'm judgmental because I think that you should send your kid to public school. Well, why? I mean, many of these people are against charter schools and voucher programs. It's not because they like public school. It's because they want them in one place to indoctrinate them, and they support teachers' unions.
Right.
They want nothing for kids. They care nothing for education. These people aren't even socialists. They're totalitarians.
Yeah.
855-450-3733. If totalitarianism is liberalism, I want nothing to do with it. Thanks very much.
Indefinite extension of the human lifespan is coming. But is it coming soon enough for you and me? That's the $80,000 question. I say $80,000 because that's what it costs to have your head cryonically frozen by Alcor. I've committed to do it. I got a life insurance policy, and I made them the beneficiaries. Bam, my best shot at living forever. Interested? Contact them at alcor.org. ALCOR.ORG. Mention my name, and I get a free year of membership.
You've been lied to. Being overweight is not about overeating, not exercising, or a lack of self-control. Diets, gyms, and pills can't fix it. It's your hormones. Go to 99skinny.com for a free video where Dr. Steven Siskin explains the four hormonal barriers to weight loss in men and women over 40.
When I first started losing the weight, all my clothes were falling off. I got some skinny jeans, and my husband was chasing me around the table again. I couldn't be happier.
Go to 99skinny.com to see this riveting free video. That's 99skinny.com.
Are you hungry for delicious, nutritious, rich, and satisfying home-cooked meals? Discover the Vita Clay 4-in-1 Smart Organic Cooker. Unglazed Zeesha Clay, an ancient secret that makes this fast multi-cooker so special. Infusing your food with incredible flavors, perfect texture, vitamins, and minerals for your good health. It's a slow cooker, rice cooker, a steamer, plus a yogurt maker. Go to VitaClayChef.com and enter promo code RADIO20 for 20% off at checkout. That's VitaClayChef.com.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait,
you're on account. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you scared me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no. That's the sound of the men working on the chain. Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com. When I found the Free State Project, I knew it was the key to achieving liberty in my lifetime. It's awesome to be surrounded by like-minded, freedom-loving activists who've moved here to New Hampshire. From politics to civil disobedience, we have it all. Where I came from, it felt that no matter what I did, liberty was dying. Perhaps you feel the same way? Call 888-377-2515 now to learn more about the Free State Project. That's 888-377-2515 or visit freestateproject.org.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live.
855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind. Again, 855-450-FREE or LRN.FM on Skype. It's Mark here with you.
And Johnson.
So I want you to go check out FortGalt.com. This is a really interesting project. What they're doing there is they're offering affordable accommodations for those looking to establish a little home base outside the U.S. It's not some sprawling valley of vast estates or anything like that. It basically looks more like a condo building or at a ski resort or some kind of they've got some pretty cool amenities and that sort of thing. It's going to be created by Benson Wood, their Unity project. So it is going to be beautiful. And you can go see the videos they have there. The mock-ups are stunning. It's amazing to go see these and the project they're putting together. Basically, you wouldn't be putting money all in up at front. This is not, even if it does go under, you wouldn't have that much of an investment to begin with. Go check it out. FortGalt.com. There's only room for about 100 people, so don't wait till the place is full. I think you're really going to find this very intriguing. I certainly have. From little tiny areas, by 4 by 11, that kind of thing. That's a pretty small room. You're talking about basically a little cell there. So it's mostly a community situation to, bigger rooms, but, quite large rooms. Whatever it is that you and your family need, you can find it at FortGalt.com. They're actually going to be in southern Chile is where they're doing their first project, but they intend to do these all around the world, and I think it's an exciting idea. FortGalt.com. Let's go to Straight Razor calling in from Texas. Straight Razor, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Good evening, gentlemen. So how about that for a government school? We need more money for art projects, but we're going to ban imagination.
Yeah.
So I was calling in about the interesting conversation about the Constitution and how the political system is working here.
Okay, before you go on with the Constitution, I want to talk about imagination for a second. I've thought about imagination as far as kids go, and I think that this is I have some questions about imagination. I don't expect you to know the answers, but I want to ask them to the ether, Straight Razor. If a kid never had anything to build imagination on, right? So my son loves to talk about Star Wars and Marvel heroes, right? Like the Star Wars characters, the Marvel heroes. I suspect he's gotten that from his dad, right? Like his dad's really into Marvel stuff and kind of like Star Wars. And, he got into it too. At some point, he'll get, pressure from friends and that sort of thing. And he'll decide what's cool there. And, imagination works on top of these things. You that laser gun doesn't kill you, it stuns you, and you're up after 5 minutes. You make all these rules and games and stuff in the process. But what would it be like if there was nothing upon which to build? If you just sort of left your kid as a blank slate, would they be more imaginative because they had to work their imagination muscles harder? Or would they be less imaginative because they didn't have much to build on in the first place?
Well, I think the issue here, though, is that they're actually kind of banning the imagination.
Sure. So I don't disagree with that.
You didn't force your child to imagine about a lightsaber or, whatever fictional characters you like.
Yeah.
They just picked up on that and took it from there.
Yeah, he likes it for that reason.
If you had said no, you can't imagine that phaser only stops somebody in their tracks. You have to imagine that it kills them. And you just ban the concept that whatever that device could only do one thing. Then you're kind of limiting the imagination to exactly what you want, which is kind of what, the school is trying to do.
That's what they're doing. Go on. What'd you call it about?
So I completely agree with you on the on the legislature having to agree at the very least 85% on every law. However, one thing that I do think we need to separate is they need to not be able to vote themselves more money, because people will still join because they know, well, everybody will just agree and I'll get more money. Plus, I don't have to do anything because no one's going to agree. So I don't ever have to be put on the spot for my beliefs.
How would they get paid then? Would it be based on the
consumer price index, or would it be the you know, people had to vote to give Congress a raise? How would Congress get a raise?
Now that's where things get kind of tough, because people have different theories. So I would say obviously you're not going to be able to leave it up to the person who's getting paid to vote on their raise.
It's a terrible idea for employees to decide, what they get paid, especially when they don't work in a for-profit organization.
Well, we should just be thanking our stars that they can't vote how many times a year they get a raise, because then we'd really be in trouble.
Yeah.
But, I think there needs to be some other way of determining that, whether it's, okay, well, under the guise of this particular Congress or whichever legislature you're looking at, the economy did this much better, or we brought in this much more money. Okay, well, maybe we can do a percentage of that based on your performance and getting us to that point.
Right. Like,
it's tough. It's a tough decision.
I think it would be interesting, because what you probably would have is Congress would then begin to occupy a sphere kind of like government school teachers. If people got to vote what government school teachers got paid, they probably would get paid even more than they do. These folks that work 9 months out of the year and they're not laying block, they generally make more than your average working folks, and they have pretty good benefits. I'm not saying teachers aren't great folks or whatever it is that I might be accused of here. It's just that I am going to say you get some time to do other work or maybe go travel or do a variety of things. And the idea that teachers are somehow underpaid in much of America sounds ludicrous to me.
Well, what about pay by performance? Because here's the thing. There are plenty of teachers out there who are not performing up to par.
Sure. Can't fire them.
They just get to ride the government gravy train, and they just read out of that book and tell your kid what to think and how to think it and when to think it, as opposed to saying, here are two topics. Why don't we go ahead and debate that and use your mind to figure out solutions to complex problems?
Well, how about we just stop funding agencies of coercion? Why in the world do we have to pay into – why does somebody like my co-host Ian or Johnson here have to pay to educate other people's kids? Even more importantly, what about my kid? I have to pay in something like – I don't know, more than about $2,000 a year is going into a school in my town that my son doesn't attend, will never attend. And so other people with cars, in many cases, much nicer than my 2002 Ford pickup truck, they drive nice cars. They can afford to educate their kid if they wanted to. But they don't. They want me to pay for it. They want my son to pay for it, because money's fungible. That's coming out of his education.
Oh, absolutely. And the other thing is you're not allowed to use those facilities. On the weekends, there's just this big open, empty lot and empty playground. So why shouldn't your kid be able to participate in after-school activities if you want
right.
them to?
Oh, in many cases, they can. Absolutely. Homeschool kids.
In the state of Texas, that's not happening. If you're homeschooling, you cannot participate in any, like, sports. For a school in your district,
really?
They will not allow it.
Yeah, I'm paying education taxes. I should be able to use the computer lab at these schools that my tax money paid for to host a class that I charge money for on the weekends. I should be able to make my money back on that facility by going and be able to teach a class there to adults. Like if I wanted to teach Photoshop, because I'm a graphic designer by trade outside of Free Talk Live, I should be able to go teach Photoshop and graphic design to people at that at that school for money on weekends.
But if you show up there during the day, you're going to get arrested. Like, you're not even allowed on the property.
Well, I think another big thing here is that people forget. Now, I'm not justifying the system. However, if the system exists, then you need to use it to your best ability to make the outcome better. So if you're in an area with a school district, you need to see what your school is doing.
Oh, nonsense. That argument that you just made is utter nonsense, because we did this here in Keene. A group of people went down, to the school board meeting. It is a completely – you will go down there, and basically these school board meetings in towns are attended by no one but people who are friends with, family with, or for the most part, employees of the education board in the area – And you will get nothing done. It will be a complete waste of your time.
How many people did you show up with, though?
Wow.
About a dozen?
Yeah.
See, I don't think dozens is enough. I think you need more than that. You
yeah.
need
to, Good luck with that.
Show me how to do it.
It needs to be like an occupation.
Yeah, I hear you.
Good luck with that.
Yeah, it's very difficult to get people to go to these things. They're like marathons. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Nesquik. Try Nesquik 4-packs, perfect for lunches and great for kids on the go. Look for it in the juice aisle. Snack time is a great chance to sneak extra calcium into your child's diet without making him feel like he's eating something he doesn't want. Serve up dairy-rich foods like smoothies, flavored milk, frozen yogurt, and string cheese. He'll love the treat, and you'll love knowing how good it is for him. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 12, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,158, up $3. Silver opened at $15.58, up 8 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $292.45. Today's precious metal prices are brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. In the news, two police officers were shot and seriously wounded early this morning outside the police department in Ferguson, Missouri. Fox News reports that St. Louis County Police Chief John Belmar held an early morning news conference and stated that a 41-year-old officer from St. Louis County was shot in the shoulder, while a 32-year-old officer from suburban Webster Groves was shot in the face. Both officers were taken to a local hospital with their conditions described as very serious. The shooting came amidst protests that followed the resignation of the town's police chief. Chief Thomas Jackson announced he would resign following a report from the U.S. Department of Justice that condemned the practices of the Ferguson Police Department. Jackson is only the latest in a line of recent departures after the Justice Department's investigation concluded. The report found that the Ferguson PD was guilty of unlawful and unconstitutional practices. The Justice Department also found widespread racism in the police department and municipal court. Despite calls to shut down the police department, Ferguson Mayor James Knowles said the city is committed to keeping the police department open. On Wednesday afternoon, protesters gathered in Decatur, Georgia, to protest the shooting death of a military veteran at the hands of a police officer. Anthony Hill was a 27-year-old military veteran suffering from bipolar disorder when he was shot by Officer Robert Olson. The officer reportedly found Hill running around naked in a suburban apartment complex. The officer said Hill came towards him and would not listen to warnings. Olson reportedly appeared shocked after the shooting and was seen sitting down on the street with his head in his hands. The Georgia Bureau of Investigation will now handle the official investigation.
Protesters rallied outside of a county courthouse and marched through the streets, shutting down busy intersections. The Liberty Beat is sponsored in part by Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. Looking to promote your business or cause to tens of thousands of loyal listeners? Well, for a limited time only, the Liberty Beat is offering you the chance to save big while spreading your message. It's simple. Just sign up for 3 months of advertising and get your fourth month free. Don't miss this unique opportunity. Just visit thelibertybeat.com/advertise and use coupon code GCN in the Describe Your Company section. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 12, 2015. Make sure you check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. On Wednesday, the Associated Press announced they were suing the State Department to force the release of emails and government documents from Hillary Clinton's time as Secretary of State. The AP filed suit after repeated Freedom of Information Act requests went unfulfilled. The requests are seeking materials related to Clinton's public and private calendars, correspondence between her and aides involved in her expected presidential campaign, and Clinton-related emails on the Osama bin Laden raid and NSA practices. Two Texas state senators have introduced a new bill that would require warrants for the use of Stingray cell phone surveillance. Senators Craig Estes and Rodney Ellis introduced Senate Bill 942, which would require warrants for GPS tracking devices, international mobile subscriber identity locators, including Stingray cell phone surveillance devices, also known as cell site simulators. On March 9th, the bill was referred to the State Affairs Committee. Stay tuned to the Liberty Beat for more on this bill. The United States is sending $75 million worth of military equipment to Ukraine. The U.S. military is sending armored Humvees, drones, and counter-mortar radars, but none of the requested lethal aid. Military officials said the new assistance is part of ongoing efforts to help Ukraine defend against aggression. The equipment includes a small Raven drone system, which can be launched by hand, as well as 30 heavily armored Humvees and 200 other regular Humvees. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Hear from speakers like Charlie Shrem, Dr. Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, and Catherine Bleich. March 28th and 29th at ACL Live at the Moody Theater. Tickets on sale now at TexasBitcoinConference.com. Use coupon code LibertyBeat for $25 off your ticket. That's coupon code LibertyBeat. This is the Liberty Beat for Thursday, March 12th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
A harrowing situation on Broad Street came to its conclusion Thursday night as a group of hostages were freed from local comedy club The Laugh Up Lounge after a tense 7-minute stand-up set.
Every once in a while, he'd grab his notebook, and I'd think maybe this is it. Maybe he's gonna let us go, but he just kept talking.
Additionally, The Onion recovered this video footage from the cell phone of one of the many captives.
Please, if someone sees this, help us. Please help.
Yeah, micromanagement.
You guys are totally gonna wang it up.
Oh my god. Oh my god, no.
Cool.
I'm not a religious person, but at one point I said the Lord's Prayer and it actually had a calming effect. Like Jesus was standing next to me and said, "You're gonna get through this."
I mean, sometimes you're just in the wrong place at the wrong time. You know, don't take life for granted because you just never know when something like this could happen. So.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. It's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever is on your mind here on this live edition of Free Talk Live. We're live 7 nights a week on Free Talk Live. We don't take off Thanksgiving, Christmas. I think we've had a live show produced every day that we've been on the air because our Sunday show is relatively new. It's only like 4 years old, but every day for like 5 or 6 years. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah.
You know, no best ofs, no, none of that stuff. Free Talk Live. We mean it when we say Free Talk Live. You can call in and talk about whatever you want, and we will be live 7 nights a week, 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. Eastern Time.
There are not a lot of other shows that can make that claim.
No, not very many, I wouldn't say. The ranks of talk radio, they keep on thinning. You know, Dennis Miller, he's out now.
Really?
Yep, he's stopped doing his program and basically is recorded now. And there were several of them that dropped out at the beginning of the year. It's amazing. And just keep on thinning.
Yep.
One thing I've also said about Free Talk Live, I expect us to be on top simply because we're younger.
That's true, too.
If you're watching on the cam at cam.freetalklive.com, you just got to watch Ian walk by in his underpants. 855-450-3733. That'll spike the cam. 855-450-free at cam.freetalklive.com. There.
Either that or you watch cam viewership just drop off the cliff.
There he is, walking by. Popsicle sticks for legs.
What's disturbing to me is that those...
That's not disturbing?
No. What's disturbing to me, particularly makes that more disturbing, is that those boxers that he was wearing match a hoodie he owns.
Oh, yeah. He really loves that pattern of cassette tapes that he's got. Go check it out at cam.freetalklive.com. There, we also have a chat room where you can chit-chat with people, if that's what you want to do. So, I got nothing to do with what happens in that room, okay? That's your business, not mine. Daylight savings time just occurred, and this is a special little axe I've got to grind, because I do think that you can sort of design the clock around, well, what works for you and what doesn't work for you, but I think it's really silly to kind of get everybody together to jump the clock forward and pull it back and that sort of thing. Now,
what percentage of the world actually observes daylight savings time?
You'd have to look that up yourself. I couldn't really tell you that. But I do know that 49 states do it. So, and I would say that most of the English-speaking world does. I know that they do over in England. But I couldn't say what percentage of the world uses daylight savings time is, I don't know. Anyway, let me go on here with daylight savings time. I was trying to look that up for you, but I just can't type it at the same time. So anyway, what I wanted to see was, I think this is important, is it valuable? So there's sort of the ethereal things of kids and school and the time of day and all that stuff. But a lot of people will advocate it for energy in savings. Hey, if we get people going at the right times, they'll use less energy or more energy. And it makes sense if you sort of make an argument, but apparently we have evidence now. So there's a state that recently went from daylight savings from not having daylight savings time to daylight savings time. That state is Indiana. For some reason, they just had to have this glorious thing called daylight savings time that the rest of us had. And I imagine it was pretty difficult if you're living in Richmond there, right on the border of Ohio and Kentucky, and everybody else is, and say you've got a business meeting across the river in Covington. You're like, oh, I got to head on over into Covington. I got a business meeting at 5 p.m. Well, it turns out somebody's been waiting for you for an hour, or they won't be there for an hour, depending on the situation. That's got to kind of be frustrating. I get it. But I just don't understand. So here we go with the energy savings that was supposed to have been had. The history of daylight savings time has been long and controversial. This is from the National Bureau of Economic Research.
Can I derail you again?
If you must.
So I want to just show you this.
Okay, I'm looking.
I'll hold it in front of the cam for the people who spiked in.
It's somebody must have said Google, because now it's printing everything I've said.
Oh yeah, okay.
So
that's horrible.
I see
a
map that's largely blue in the United States and Europe, but most of the world not. So daylight savings time has been dropped in most of the geographic world, including Russia. China, India. So there's as far as population goes, you've pretty much got the population centers.
It's just certainly interesting that a lot of the world seems to be dropping daylight savings time.
Yeah.
Like they're giving up on it, except for the United States, and parts of Australia and South America.
The United States won't give up on imperial measurements either.
Right.
I mean, why in the world are we still using feet and pounds
right.
when we have a far superior system called the metric system? Why miles?
Right.
5,280 feet? Who came up with this crap? I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. But God knows they tried, and Jimmy Carter tried.
He tried to switch the country to metrics. I think you just have to pull the signs down and tell everybody this is how things are going to be. I mean, this is one area where I would go totally totalitarian on somebody. I'd be like, if I was king for a day, we would rip down every single government sign that used some kind of imperial measurement and put up one that was metric. Now, I understand you couldn't get the government to work that quickly, but I suppose if I chopped off a few heads early in the morning, that I could might be able to get something to happen by 5 p.m., right? I might need a week as king to get this done. But I would just shove this down the throat of America because, I mean, sometimes in life, somebody's got to make the hard choices, the better choices, and this is one of them. The metric system is so superior to what we have. And, you know, I mean, please call in at 855-450-FREE or LRN.FM and tell me why. If you believe in the free market so thoroughly, tell me why the free market hasn't worked its way, or the market, I should say, because there's no such thing as a free market currently. Why hasn't the market worked its way around the government and its antiquated measuring systems? The government actually tried to bring the metric system on. We could all agree that it's better, I think. I suppose you could call in and disagree that it's better at 855-450-FREE or 855-450-3733.
Are you just positing a question? Do you think you might have an answer?
I have no answer.
I don't even tell you either, actually. You kind of stumped me.
No
idea. I was just sitting there pondering them like, wow, that's a really fair point.
People don't like change is the reason that I would say. But even with my son, I don't want to teach him this old crappy system. But what am I going to teach him? Metrics? So that he can't work with anybody else? Oh, yes, that's a kilogram. Nobody has any idea what he's talking about. Yeah, they got to do the math 2.2 times.
Okay. Well, you sure got to debate that this is a better system because inch, I mean, you can just look at your finger. And then the foot, you just look at your foot.
It's just common sense. A man's foot. There's no doubt about it. But 12 inches in a foot, I mean,
12 inches, you got the inches, you count the fingers, and that makes the foot.
Yeah. But, you know, 12 is a pretty good number when you're using it for measurements. I mean, it's good. It's divisible by 3, divisible by 4, divisible by 2. Whereas 10, not quite as divisible. I understand why 12s were popular at one point, but they just aren't as easy to count by. And I just don't understand why this system still exists. I would love somebody to tell me why the marketplace hasn't replaced. I mean, because it's on every can of soda. Look, you've got a can of soda right in front of you, Johnson.
Sure.
How many milliliters is that can of Dr. Pepper?
355.
355, or 12 ounces.
12 fluid ounces.
So they've got, yeah, and the fluid ounces versus 12 weight, weight ounces. So, you know, there's that confusion, too, because a fluid ounce isn't the same as a weight ounce, and I think it's water is the one thing that they weigh the same on. But this is confusing systems. How many teaspoons in that ounce? How many ounces in a teaspoon? Oh, God. Killing me. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live. I hate that system. Imperial system. 855-450-FREE.
Policies issued by American General Life Insurance Company, Houston, Texas. Not available in all states. For details, visit AIGdirect.com.
It takes a lot of courage to face your own death, but I'm glad I finally did. See, I was putting off getting life insurance to protect my family, even though I knew it was important. Then my neighbor's husband died. I watched her struggle emotionally and financially. It really made me face reality. If my husband died, how would I pay the mortgage, the car payments, or keep up the life the kids and I had? I realized I needed to get us life insurance right away. So I called AIG Direct. In less than 5 minutes, I had a quote. I was shocked at how affordable it is. Just $14 a month for $250,000 of term life coverage. I feel so much better knowing my family has protection.
Call AIG Direct right now for a free, no-obligation quote. The call takes less than 5 minutes, and you can save up to 70%. Call now, 1-800-463-9184. That's 1-800-463-9184. 1-800-463-9184.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
This is a national health care alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. So if you're on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. We also have other pain-relieving braces, too, for your shoulder, ankle, or back. You may be eligible to get these items and more at little or no out-of-pocket cost. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to help you, so please call now. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963. 800-301-2963.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about whatever's on your mind on this live edition of Free Talk Live. It's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
And you can use 855-450-FREE, or you can use LRN.FM to call us on Skype. Usually it sounds a bit better if you do that, so that's certainly an option. It's LRN.FM. If you now, obviously, if you're going to be on the internet, you need to protect yourself. Your internet service provider is likely saving all of your surfing history. Criminals are sniffing your Wi-Fi packets, and governments and corporations are limiting what you can see on the internet. ProXPN can solve all of that. Simply download their app for Windows, Mac, iOS, Androids, or Linux. Android or Linux. And no more prying and spying. One account works for all your devices. There's no need to have a separate account for each device. Just go to proxpn.com/FTL and use promo code FTL50. And you'll get 50% off of an annual account. It's basically, that's $5 a month. So with FTL50, you get a savings for the lifetime of the account, no matter which premium account you go with. So it's not like the first year or something like that. This is forever and ever, as long as you use coupon code FTL50. So you don't want to not use it. And Free Talk Live gets credit for it, so please do that. With the premium account, you get unlimited bandwidth with servers all around the world to access, so you can look like you're coming from the Netherlands or Singapore or Dallas or wherever you want to be from. And it helps you get past regionally blocked websites, privately torrent, ProXPN doesn't keep records of your online habits at all. You get all of that with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Go to proxpn.com/FTL. Use promo code FTL50 and get a great discount on privacy. That is priceless. It's proxpn.com/FTL, FTL50. Let's go to Rob in Michigan calling to hopefully solve my problems with the Imperial system. Hey, Rob, you're on Free Talk Live.
Not Rob, Ralph.
All right. Ralph.
Okay, anyways, listen, I'm sitting here kind of laughing because I'm listening to you today, and I've listened to you before, of course, I called in another time, but anyways, you talk about freedom and liberties and so forth like that, and then you go on a fund the metric system saying that if you were king for a day, you'd chop a couple of heads off.
You better believe it.
I mean, come on, don't be hypocritical.
Mark is a hypocrite. That's his defining factor on Free Talk Live is that he's a minarchist.
Well, you know what? Too bad. You know what? He said he'd get things to happen. Yeah, you know what he'd get to happen? He'd get me to happen on him. I'd open a can of you-know-what on him.
If anyways, I'm chopping off heads in Washington, D.C., Ralph, you're not going to do anything about it in Michigan. The fact is, your government's killing people around the world, and you haven't done crap about it.
Excuse me. I have done crap about it, and I'm doing crap about it every day. Every day I go out. Matter of fact, you know what? I can't even walk down the street of this small town I live in because people walk to the other side to avoid me.
Oh, you sound like me then.
Well, anyways, the point is, you know, here's the thing. You know, you can teach both systems, and, you know, as us old farts die off, then you can convert it completely over to the metric system. But here's the thing.
But, Ralph, they did that to me in school.
No, wait, whoa. When I'm outside working in the farm here,
yep.
Okay, when I need to measure something off and I don't have a tape measure or anything with me,
yep.
You know what I use to mark it off? My feet. You know why? 12 inches. Well, actually, they're 13 inches. But, you know, I can go roughly by that.
Yeah, you can get it close.
You know what I'm saying?
Sure.
So, you know, if I'm going by the metric system, now it's 10 inches. You know, and I'm like, oh, crap, now we got some division to do and everything else, you know? I mean, I have to carry pen and paper with me. Where now I can, you know,
couldn't
I can
you
go
just
out there kind of mark it off?
Couldn't you just use your feet and say it's 3 decimeters? I mean, it's about that too.
Oh, for pity's sake!
Not good enough. All right, so I want to rebut this part though, Ralph. They taught me the metric system in school back in the 80s. I was in school starting in 1976 in kindergarten through 1989, and I learned the metric system. I understand it, and I don't use it. I barely even remember it because it doesn't get you got to use something for it to be a value.
Well, see, I do use the metric system.
What for?
You know, and I like both of them, you know, but the thing is like I said, you know, hey, when all of us older people die off, you know what? Then switch it over completely, no problem. But you know what? This is a country of freedom, and that's what I like about it.
This is not a country of freedom.
Like this show. Wait a minute. Just like this show, I have the right to speak my mind.
You do.
You have a right to rebut it. But the point is we still both have rights as long as we don't take and infringe on each other's rights. And see, that's where a lot of people go wrong. I listen to a lot of your callers, and I just want to smack them up alongside the head. Not physically, but you know that. You know, it's like
rhetorical smack.
You know? Yeah. You know, sometimes I'm the kind of guy you got to hit in the head with a 2x4 to get my attention.
The rhetorical 2x4.
I'm there. You know what I'm saying? I'm there. I'll listen. But the point is, you know, you got all these people wanting freedom and this and that. And how many people, and they, you know, how many times I've heard people say, we need to write our senator. I'm like, oh, my goodness, what the hell have we been doing for the last 40 years? You know, I mean,
writing
I can
senators.
Go all the way back. I can go all the way back to Nixon. Okay, and well, a little bit further, but, you know, that's neither here nor there. But anyways, the point is you know how many times people wrote in this? Nothing changes. These people,
nope.
The definition of politician is a liar. I mean, they tell you one thing and they do the other. It's just that simple.
Once yeah, I like liars and thieves. Because, I mean, basically
well, you know,
it's the same thing.
Up front with you.
Yeah.
You know, no, wait a minute. A liar and thief is up front with you. If he says he's going to steal from me, he's going to steal from you. That's all there is to
it. Which thief does that?
You know what I'm saying? They're up front with you.
Nah. I mean, they're all, I mean, lying is synonymous with thievery and thievery is synonymous with lying. I mean, it's basically all the same. I have never met the upfront thief. And having spent some time in prison, I suspect I've probably met a few more professional ones than most.
So I don't know. I think that, you know, private market thieves are no better than public sector thieves.
Well, they all need to get a good booting, you know what? But the point is, you know, I really like listening to you guys, but, you know, come on. Don't get hypocritical on me here because it drives me nuts. I'm trying to get work done here.
We're disturbing Ralph. Thanks for the call, Ralph. Appreciate it. 855-450-FREE. Hey, look. First off, I only said if I was king, and I only suggested that I would do it to the king's men, right? Like, these are government workers. The intention of getting government workers to pull down government signs by the end of the day. Because I consider government workers to be, well, shiftless, lazy, inefficient, those kind of things. Certainly not every single one of them, but if you can imagine what it would take, the Herculean task of trying to get the United States switched over to the metric system in one day, there's really only one way to do that, and it's probably chopping heads off. Mm. And worst case scenario, you probably chop the heads off some higher level bureaucrats anyway, and who cares?
The question is if these government workers were to continue eating donuts, how many stone would they get gained?
Why don't we use that weight any longer? No, obviously, I'm never going to be king for a day. And, you know, no one in their right mind would make me king for a day. But I'd also like to talk about some other things I'd do. You know what makes me so angry?
You're just continuing the line of hypocritical nonsense, aren't you?
We're from Sarasota, Florida. Just south of Sarasota, Florida is a place called Venice. Not Venice, Italy. Venice, Florida. There's also a Venice, California. Why in the world? What makes these places think they can call themselves the same thing as Italy? There's all kinds of great names in the world. Come up with a new name. What is Sarasota? I have no clue. They just kind of made a word up.
Sarasota.
Keen. I would assume it's somebody's last
Sarasota
name.
Sarasota is probably actually an original name because it's based off of something Indian.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges start a conversation with your neighbor or your doctor or your family or your school. Now there's teachers and lawyers and business executives, and they all wear shiny badges and they all reject the state. Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges show the world that you reject coercion and aggression and oppression by the state. Shinybadges.com.
This is Holly Thomas, Group Vice President of Cause Marketing for Macy's. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. That's why Macy's is committed to raising funds through our employees, customers, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin? Any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used, and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in here and participate in our conversation about imperial measurements or the metric system or, you know, towns being named the same thing. That just burns me.
I'd love to talk about that once you're when we get a moment to talk about a little bit about the name of because you said Sarasota, you know, you're talking about names. Let's touch upon how they formed that name.
Okay. Well, if you want to get some gold and silver, you can go to gold.freetalklive.com. We've got some great pieces over there, coins and rounds, whatever it is that you need. Got at great prices. It's gold.freetalklive.com. Now's a good time to get into precious metals because prices are low. gold.freetalklive.com. And we've got a toll-free number for you there, or I can give it to you here, 877-857-9938. 877-857-9938, gold.freetalklive.com.
You know who really wanted some gold?
Spanish conquistadors.
Who were settling Florida.
Yes.
And they are who named...
I don't think there's any gold in Florida.
They are who... Yeah, it's true, but they thought that there was, for sure.
We're willing to kill people over it.
And they are who named Sarasota. Zarazote. Apparently, it was the Spanish name originally on maps dating back to the 1840s.
Zarazote isn't a Spanish name.
Zarazote. Yes, it is. Sure,
okay.
It is.
What's it mean?
It means, apparently, it's associated with the area from the beginning of European contracts. It may be named for a word in the indigenous Calusa language.
Okay.
Whose meaning may be point of rocks or place of the dance.
All right, so if it's in Calusa, fine.
Well, it goes in and say, it's, some people believe a fanciful story created for a popular early 20th century pageant held in Sarasota that it was named after the daughter of a famous explorer, Hernando de Soto's daughter, Sarah, according to the Florida League of Cities, FLC. The name first appeared in print as Zarazote on a 1763 land grant map.
Got it. So there you go. That's kind of interesting.
So that's, you know, how these people are stealing
their names.
I know
we're on in Sarasota, but
they're stealing their, you know, so at least Sarasota is a somewhat unique name, even though it's still stolen.
Well, I don't know that it's stolen. It's evolved.
Sure.
And I don't think there is, that I know of, another Sarasota in the world. I also don't think there's another Bradenton.
Right.
But, I mean, so this is all I'm asking for from our city fathers around the world is, hey, when you name your city something, can't you do something besides name it after city? You got a wife, name it after her. You got a daughter or a son. You've got your dad. I mean, you know, your favorite dog.
So who gets to keep Keene?
There's a lot of Keens.
There they are.
Yeah.
It's like Keene, New York, Keene, Texas, Keene, New Hampshire, Keene, California. Like, there's like so many Keens.
Well, as an arbiter, if I was to rule the world, I would be the arbiter of who got to keep the name and who didn't. I would base it mostly on lineage and size of the town. So, for instance, I've been shown the dilemma of Boston. Boston, Massachusetts is named after a place in England called Boston. Had you ever heard of it before?
Nope.
Yep, there you go. Well, I think that I would be prepared to rob the original Boston of its Bostonian title in order to give it to the bigger Boston, simply because I feel like, well, you know, this one just more people call this place Boston. But every place else that calls itself Boston, you know, then they're out of luck. The Boston in England, maybe I'd give them some kind of money out of the Royal Treasury to make them feel better or something. Everybody gets a dollar. I don't know. But, I mean, you know, Venice, Italy, that's a pretty clear one, right? Venice, Florida, Venice, California, and Venice, sure, God knows where else. They're going to have to figure it out on their own.
Well, Venice, California, I feel like Venice, New California Hampshire. Isn't actually Venice, California. It's Venice Beach, California.
Yeah, there's, I think you might be sliding in under the wire.
I think maybe we should change it so it's like Venice Biatch. You know, something like that. Just change
that's
it right. A little bit.
Anything that says Biatch, that would be funny as it could possibly be. Going back to daylight savings time, rather than my ramblings. The daylight savings time, we're reading here from the National Bureau of Economic Research, is the daylight savings time's been, you know, purported as an energy saving system. But apparently, starting here, focusing on residential electricity demand, we conduct the first ever study that uses micro data on households to estimate the overall daylight savings time effect. This is from Indiana. Indiana recently switched from not using daylight savings time to using daylight savings time. So we can see the difference of households in southern Indiana for 3 years. Our main finding is that contrary to the policy's intent, daylight savings time increases residential electricity demand. Estimates of the overall increase are approximately 1%, but we find that the effects is not constant throughout the daylight savings time period. Daylight savings time causes the greatest increase in electricity consumption in the fall, when the estimates range from 2 and 4%. These findings are consistent with simulation results that point to a trade-off between reducing demand for lighting and increasing demand for heating and cooling.
Right.
We estimate a cost of increasing electricity bills in Indiana to households of $9 million per year. We also estimate social costs of increasing pollution emissions.
Why would daylight savings time increase the demand for heating and cooling?
Because people get up earlier. When you're asleep in your bed, it's okay for the heat to be at 62 because you're under covers. But when you get up, you're like, oh, man, it's cold. Somebody turn on the heat.
Right.
And you have to have it at 68 or 70 or, for the real wusses out there, 73. I mean, so this would be an argument for daylight savings time in the South, by the way, but not in the North. But I just feel like businesses can change their hours if that's what they want to do. There was a sign posted. I saw a little sheet of paper on that was posted on Facebook of Home Depot changing its hours for the summer or whatever. And why can't they? Why can't businesses just change their hours? I make appointments with people based on, when I say I'm going to call. I'll call you at 11 a.m. or you call me at 11 a.m., that kind of thing. Sure, if you have a business, that people might have to remember summer hours, but if lots of retail businesses just do summer hours, then it wouldn't be that unusual. Why do we have to do this whole clock-changing thing? People have heart attacks. Daylight savings time kills because people aren't used to it. A certain amount of the population drops off dead as a result of daylight savings time. I think kids are already sent to school too early in the morning in many cases.
It's ridiculous. That is another thing about government school that I think should be changed immediately. It's like one of those things where it's like kids should not have to be getting up that early in the morning. And it really only has to do with because the schools are being used as a daycare center and parents need to get to work.
It's not just that. It's because the buses.
They want to use the same buses for the high schoolers that they use for the middle schoolers and for the elementary school kids. Sure. So the elementary school kids go to school after the middle schoolers, who go after the high schoolers. So we have to get the high schoolers in school by 7:30, so we can do the middle schoolers by 8:30. And
wow, so this just brings a thought to my head. So if we get everyone having self-driving cars, that could be something that could be changed very easily.
How's that?
Because every kid is just pressing a button. It's just a car that's not in use comes and picks them up individually.
Wouldn't the cars be busy? Like, here's what I'm thinking is what you're talking about is a world where we have self-driving cars. Likely at that point, people don't even own cars anymore.
Right.
You'll just have essentially taxi cabs that you use to get to one place to another.
Like Uber, kind of, or something like that. Like, where you just press a button and one of these self-driving cars, like, that's nearest by, gets a signal and comes and picks you up and takes you to your location. Or you want to deliver a package, same thing. You just put it in the car, send your thing, the destination, and it goes and...
But won't the won't all the cars be occupied at 9 a.m. or 8 a.m. or whenever people
all
are trying
cars?
To get to work?
No, of course not.
Well, then won't
there
the many
be,
of the
there
cars
should
just
be a
be,
surplus of cars?
Won't the cars just be there? Be a whole surplus of cars during the during the midday when people aren't driving around?
Right. So it would make natural sense for that to them to back the school time up to be in the midday where there's tons of cars.
Yeah, I think that what it would probably do is put pressure on certain businesses and organizations to start and end at different times. Sure. School already ends early.
I don't think that pressure is even necessary. I think businesses would do that naturally.
855 450 free.
Well, I did it. I finally left the empire behind. And now that I'm safely settled in Chile, I'm gathering with others like me to build a new community called Fort Galt. Fort Galt is designed to be the ideal home base for professionals and their families to live and work in peace. If you're ready to ditch the superstate and bring your business to freer lands, visit us online at fortgalt.com. That's fortgalt.com.
In a trial by jury, the primary function of a juror is not to dispense punishment to the accused. It is to protect your fellow citizens from being unjustly deprived of their life, liberty, or property. As a juror, you can say no to unjust laws and prevent government abuses of power by refusing to convict. Legislative, executive, judicial. The fourth branch of government is we the people. Find out more from the Fully Informed Jury Association at fija.org.
By now, you may have heard a bit about Bitcoins, but did you know Bitcoins are now over an $8.5 billion market? And did you know that over 65,000 businesses now accept Bitcoins? Listen, if you're already earning Bitcoins or trying to make money in the Bitcoin market, you've got to know BidBit.co. Why? Because BidBit.co is where you can easily receive Bitcoins by selling and auctioning off your own personal items or promote business products and services for Bitcoins. You heard right. Whether personal or business, you can now buy, sell, and auction your product and services quickly, easily, and securely for Bitcoin at BidBit.co, the first and only marketplace website to offer BidBit escrow, a proprietary technology which gives buyers and sellers security and peace of mind because all transactions are protected. Start today. It's free to join, free to post, free to auction, and free to bid at BidBit.co. Buy, sell, bid, or auction everything Bitcoin. That's www.bidbit.co. BidBit.co.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, Buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. 3. Give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
I'm Mark Stevens of the No Stay Project, and are you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Stop using their money. There is an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. By using their money, you're only helping the government. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available right now. Learn it, use it, spread it. So get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733 or lrn.fm on Skype. It's Mark with you.
And Johnson.
Go get archives for free, going back a very long time, years, at archives.freetalklive.com. They're free. Archives.freetalklive.com.
So Twitter has some news today that's kind of interesting. Twitter has gone about banning users from posting revenge porn and revealing information about people as it tries to crack down on abuse on its platform. CEO Dick.
So revenge porn is when you've got naked pictures of an ex
or video
and you decide to share that with people in
as
order
revenge.
To yeah, just because you're a jerk,
right.
Essentially.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly.
I don't know. I suppose you'd have to be pretty angry, right, to do such a thing.
I don't know. There's probably some guys who are just complete losers who aren't necessarily that angry. They're just like, meh. Share it with my buddies, sure. Mm. Post it on the internet. Nothing will happen. Yeah, sure is. So CEO Dick Costello admitted last month that the microblogging site still sucks at dealing with abuse and trolls. And since then, it has rolled out new tools to combat harassment and other problems. The latest tools explicitly ban users from posting personal information and intimate videos and photos of anyone else. Doxing involves posting information, documents, abbreviated to docs, about users that want to be anonymous. If users violate that ban, their accounts will be locked unless they delete the information. If users break the rule repeatedly, their account will be suspended.
So giving information out on other people?
Yeah.
This can be very valuable at times.
Sure can. And that's where I think this is dangerous. The article goes on to say, but the site is likely to run into the problem of the ease with which users can create new accounts on the platform, a problem which it has run into in its attempts to shut down the profiles of ISIS extremists as well as Twitter trolls.
Well, I'd say that so the internet is going to be very difficult to make more free.
Mm-hmm.
Make less free, especially Twitter and things like this. I mean, it's just people want to have more freedom. And if you don't want to be doxxed and you don't want to have revenge porn put on the internet,
right.
I suggest A, not taking pictures of yourself naked, and B, trying to keep your information as best you can off of the internet. It's hard.
That's next to impossible to do.
Well, then stop being a jerk.
Yeah.
Most of the people that I see that get doxxed, I'm certainly not every one of them, but most of them I see deserve it.
Right.
You're like, oh, well, you know, I don't care.
Yeah. It's like when you're being a jerk, you know, and somebody's going to reveal stuff about you. You know, that's like you go around attacking people, you're going to get attacked back. So it says the site could reduce the ease with which users can make new accounts with using tools like Internet Protocol Address Blocking, IP blocking. But the site's anonymity and ease of use has also made it popular with political activists and other people who need to stay out of sight. The decision comes soon after Reddit banned revenge porn last month. Last month, the site reversed its policy on posting nude photos and videos after a high-profile leak of sexual images, including those of Jennifer Lawrence. Which, you know, we all remember that.
I did not look at any of those pictures. I just didn't see any particular reason to go out hunting them down.
Sure.
I know, you know, this is important to some people, not important to me. But, and I felt bad for the gal. you know, I mean, I wouldn't want that to happen to me.
Well, there were lots and lots of celebrities that were kind of exposed in that.
I get it. I wouldn't, you know, I wouldn't particularly want that to happen to me, but, you know, I guess as a man, you just don't care as much about your nakedness as women tend to care about it.
Right.
You know, they're taught their whole lives that they've got something very, very special to keep hidden. And you've got to protect it, girls. You know, so, you know, guys are taught. At least they're not taught that.
Right.
And I think that they're much more likely. They seem to have a larger propensity for wanting to give it away, as it were.
This doxing thing, though, it really does concern me, because a lot of the times the doxing has occurred is it's to help the authorities find a criminal, you know, like a sexual predator or something. It's like, here's the documentation that we found, or somebody who's like, you know, scamming the media, or it's a lot of times when doxing happens, it's happening because some very bad people are doing bad things and they're getting exposed and they need to be exposed.
Yeah, some people abuse doxing. There's no doubt about it.
Sure.
But many times when I've seen doxing done, you're like, thank goodness somebody did this. Because
right.
What it does is it causes a person who's emboldened by anonymity
right.
to run back in the shadows and, you know, just to disappear.
Right.
Because, you know, this is how trolls work. They're you know, sadly, this is how some people want to behave on the internet, which is badly, very badly, and that once it's revealed who they are, they're better about it.
Right.
Now, obviously, you can go on Facebook where people have their names right there, and they'll still act like jerks.
Yeah.
You know, Google has basically made it so that you know, the worst of the trolls seem to live on YouTube, right?
Right.
And those people have their names out there.
I suspect the other thing that's going to happen with this is that what's going to happen is that people will be doxxed off of Twitter. They'll be anonymously, and people somehow link to another website or something like that that has their documents. You know, like that'll say, like, okay, here's this information about this person,
yeah.
And they just won't post it directly on Twitter.
Sure, they'll just post it to a blog.
You know, they'll say this Twitter username, which now is extremely Googleable, you know, or searchable or whatever, that you can find that this Twitter username, and here's all that person's information.
Yep. So, you know, even if you just have a link.
And that way, all you have to, you don't even have to have the link. You just have to say, this person has been doxxed.
Yep.
That's it.
Yep.
That's all you would need to say. And then can they block you for saying that?
No, I don't think they could.
Because if you say this person's been doxxed, then all anybody would have to do is like Google that username and know that person, like, it's like, okay.
Twitter has to know they can't control this.
Right.
They have to know that. Revenge porn, pretty nasty practice,
right.
And I can see why they would want to you know, ban somebody's account for that kind of thing, but doxing, I don't see that as nearly the biggest problem. And I've been doxed before on the internet.
Sure.
I mean, there's an organization called Stop Free Keen,
yep.
which seems for whatever reason go after me whenever they get an opportunity. I'm not even part of Free Keen.
I got the Stop Free Keen started targeting me because I actually doxed one of their leaders,
yep.
one of their founders, because you know, one of the founders' spouses stole $10,000 from the bank.
Yeah.
You know.
So, you know, all the pejoratives they use to describe people in Free Keen, many of these people really aren't that great either. So, anyway, I think doxing is valuable, and I've been doxed. It hasn't resulted in anything particularly terrible for me because I don't really care what it, you know, ultimately, if people want to find out what my real name is, it's not Mark Edge, it's Mark Edgington. If people want to go and try to figure out where I live or things like that, they can probably get that done, and there's not much I can do about it. I mean, you know, am I just not going to go on the radio and speak my mind? Am I going to huddle in fear? Am I going to move every year with the desire to sort of hide my location, my identity? You know, talk show hosts have been killed in this country for their opinions. There's no doubt about it, but you can't live in fear.
Right.
So somebody getting doxxed on Twitter is, I mean, I don't know how many cases there are of somebody getting killed over it, but probably not very many. So I guess cry me a river. Big deal. You know, I mean, if you don't want to get doxxed, don't go out. Don't put yourself out there. They're not doxxing ordinary people that aren't doing anything.
Right. Yeah, it's normally, I mean, and again, like I said, the only time I've seen doxxing happen for the most part is because someone is like, you know, killing cats, or, you know, they're doing things that are just generally bad, awful, nasty things, you know, like, again, sexual predators, you know, just things like that. And
I mean, I can see that there are times where it's like, okay, this person should be left alone, but...
When they put a video up of them torturing a cat, I've seen these.
Sure.
I feel no pity for that person getting doxxed.
Well, let me bring this up, because I did just bring up the sexual predator example. So, like, let's say someone is on the sexual predator list, and they are on the predator list because they, you know, urinated in public.
Okay.
You know, they're on for a bad reason, or yep, because they were 18 and had a 17-year-old girlfriend, you know, at one point, or something like that. But then they're on the list, and then no one can tell what they are. They move to a new area, yep, right? And someone sees that they're on a list, on one of these registries or whatever, doesn't know the reason why, because that's not published along with the registry, and doxes them.
Yeah, sure.
You know, that could be an example of the, yep, type of thing that happens and is probably happening.
Ultimately,
it's a problem.
If somebody commits some kind of, sexual deviant act or whatever and gets a charge from it 10 or 15 years ago, they're still on the sexual predator list.
Right.
Why would you want to go after a person who's lived a relatively clean life after
that? Because there are crazies that want to, you know, like, there are lots,
right,
of crazies out
just
there.
Just a bunch of nuts that are, right, worried about these,
right,
things.
But
so,
that's what I'm just using that as an example of, okay, maybe I can see that, you know, maybe I can see that there are certain situations where doxing is a bad thing. I don't know. Maybe we'll get more opinions. Maybe more people call in tomorrow night.
Tomorrow night, you can catch us at 7 p.m. Eastern time at freetalklive.com, your local station.
Maybe they'll post to our Facebook page and they'll dox all of us.
You can find that at facebook.freetalklive.com. It's been Mark with you.
And Johnson.
A Rasmussen poll reveals that nearly all American voters share a deep fear of botching another election, with most voters admitting that selecting candidates for public office is something they're historically just not particularly good at.
I really hope I don't completely fuck things up as usual, but you never know, things do happen.
According to the poll, 3/4 of voters said election day panic would cause them to base their vote entirely on hearsay, while 93% acknowledged that they only recognize names of local candidates from signs along state highways. In Cedar Rapids, Iowa, stunned friends and acquaintances expressed shock and disbelief when a body found in the woods turned out not to be Justin. Local residents found the naked corpse draped over a tree stump Saturday, and as news spread, many found themselves struggling to comprehend how it wasn't Justin lying dead in the forest.
I heard the news, and I still can't come around to it. I just can't imagine that it's not Justin there lying dead in the woods. Are they absolutely sure it's not him?
Friends and family are still urging authorities to double-check the body, or at the very least, bring in Justin as a suspect.
This is the Onion News Network.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this.